Everybody should have one talent. What's yours?
Telling lies, impersonating practically anybody.
An all-star cast in the network premiere, The Talented Mr. Ripley, Monday at 9 on BBC One.
Just for this week, Fame Academy will be opening its doors tomorrow. Fame Academy tomorrow at 5:35 on BBC One.
It's a game of chance in the National Lottery draw at 5 to 9 tonight on BBC One. But right now, it's a question of brain power. Time to test the nation once more. And don't forget, Freeview, satellite and cable viewers can press their red button to play along with the national quiz with BBC iQ.
To Test the Nation, the biggest live interactive test on British television. Tonight, we'll be finding out who's best at general knowledge across the country. And live, here in the studio, as you can see, grounded for the night, the cabin crew. Pitted against them and already on the edge of their seats, the football supporters. Domestic goddesses. Plumbers. Estate agents, and last but not least, the examiners. Now please welcome your quiz masters for the night, Anne Robinson and Phillip Schofield.
Yes, we're here to test the nation, this time on general knowledge. Now we're live, and before we start, congratulations to England, congratulations to Scotland, and there's lots more fun to be had even though the football's over. Tonight's test is as interactive as you want it to be, a chance to ease back into everyday life after the holidays. Above all, this test will find out how much you notice or pick up around you. It really is about general knowledge. By the end of the evening, you'll know how you rate compared to the people in the studio, the rest of your family, and the whole of the UK.
Now, do you have anyone in your family who constantly shouts out the answers? Would they have the guts to take part in a quiz here? Tonight is a test of the stuff you soak up as you get on with everyday life, or indeed the ironing, domestic goddesses. It's not something our plumbers know very much about, eh? This may very well be your night, guys.
Now, at the moment, the examiners are looking very smart. Boots on the other foot. We'll soon change that. The great thing about Test the Nation is that the groups you think are going to be very bright often let themselves down. Oh, yes. Right, a few tips for the evening. The most important one, once we start the 70 questions, please stick with it. It's the only way you'll be able to work out your score. There are picture rounds and film clips, so if you need your glasses, go and get them now. Also, very important, for the first time ever, you can play using your mobile. More on that in a minute.
Are you using your mobile?
No, that's not what my thumb is for.
Fair enough, then. If you want to do the quiz online, and a few months ago, over a million people did the IQ test that way, then log on to www.bbc.co.uk/testthenation. Now, please do it now, as kickoff is only a matter of minutes away. Now, if you've got digital TV, then press the red button on your remote control now and follow the on-screen instructions. But please, and this is really very, very important, don't change channels, otherwise you will entirely lose your score. You can also use the scorecards from major national publications. If you've got a paper in the house, see if you can find one of those. That's what it looks like. Or, of course, you can download one of these from the website.
Now, there's one more group joining in tonight, seven very brave celebrities. They have beauty, ladies and gentlemen. They have wit. But whether they're any good at general knowledge, we'll have to find out. Here they come.
Is he as smart as he tells us to be? Could it be a case of style over substance? It's Lawrence Llewellyn Bowen. She plays PC Jodie Flynn in Merseybeat, but will she be clued up tonight? It's actress Josie Darby. Will his wit stand up to scrutiny? It's comedian Ed Burr. All the way from Albert Square, it's ex-landlord of the Queen Vic, Dirty Dan Watts, alias actor Leslie Grantham. She's certainly street smart, but would she do well in her very own pub quiz? It's Corrie's Sally Lindsay. Can his general knowledge go the distance? It's sprinter Darren Campbell. Finally, country woman, cook, and best-selling writer. She's one fab lady. It's Clarissa Dixon Wright.
Okay, we'll be chatting to the celebs in a minute. A bit of fun first. Put everyone in quiz mode.
Good evening. Your name, please.
Good evening.
You have chosen to answer the question before last each time. Is that correct?
Charlie Smithers.
Who wrote the words of Little Things Mean a Lot?
Was it Snow White?
You don't know who sang In the Summertime, do you?
Mungo Jerry.
What was the date of the Battle of Culloden?
It's Cheating Incorporated. How can I help you?
When was the Battle of Culloden?
God, how ignorant can you get?
Choose a topic.
Sport.
What's the capital of Iceland?
Reykjavik. Is that still a sport?
You, all right. You, couple of Borneo.
Don't care.
See, it doesn't happen.
What is a female swan called?
A criminal sentence in England can only be freed by the Queen's what?
Pardon?
Pardon is correct.
Female swan called.
Who is better known as the Little Trump?
Don't you dare, Charlie.
It's a female swan, three letters.
Who won the FA Cup in 1930? Arsenal!
Correct, Arsenal.
Got it. It's a bit.
Five, four, two, and one.
No, the answer is Charlie Chaplin.
No, that's a bit red.
What does the excrement of a gazelle smell of?
Scumbag Neil.
Can I go to the toilet?
Excrement of a gazelle. What do you do? Go about sniffing it.
What was the nationality of the painter Botticelli?
Indian.
Where did the Allied conference take place after the Second World War?
India.
Who was the Third Earl?
India.
Cumulonimbus. Cumulus.
Indian.
Where did...
India.
Why...
Indian.
I've started, so I'll...
India. Under pressure.
Classic celebrities under pressure, but of course our celebrities that are under pressure this evening are sitting right here in front of me. All right, team? Everything okay? Looking good? Leslie, how do you, as an actor, how do you remember your words? Do you have a good memory?
Well, badly, but, yeah, you just read them until they come out badly.
have you got a good memory?
Yes, Paul.
What about when it comes to sort of everyday general knowledge? I mean, how do you think you're going to do this evening?
Very well.
So you, as far as you're concerned, definitely top of the bunch here in the celebrities.
Oh, definitely pick of the bunch.
Okay, all right. Well, that may very well come back to haunt you. You know that, don't you?
Most bunches do.
We've got Sally here, who your dad owns a pub in Manchester.
He does, yeah. We won't have a pub quiz. The two could be playing darts and crib and dominoes and drinking.
And what about your general knowledge?
It's not bad, actually, for a bird.
Have you ever played the dumb blonde card?
Well, I'm not blonde.
What an admission.
Sorry. I'm sort of an off sort of dishwash brown.
You used it a bit when you're parking your car, though.
Oh, yeah, crying my eyes out if I get a parking ticket. Crying my eyes out. and it never works, but...
And our sprinter here, Darren, of course, who has just won his bronze... He's definitely not blonde. Won our bronze medal at the World Championships. In... What does it take for you to win?
Try and overcome your fear. And I'm terrified right now.
Are you? No, don't be. Listen, you're amongst friends. No problem at all. I tell you what, before, let's just loosen you up a wee bit here. Let's revel in that glory one more time. Here's Darren. Second from the end, nearest the camera, wearing a white top with a red stripe.
And they get away first time. Kim Collins got a very good start on the far side and leads it at the moment. Kim Collins, the Commonwealth champion in the lead. Chambers is coming, and so is Darrell Brown. But Collins is going to take this one. Morrow on the line. It's very close. Very, very close. Campbell has got the bronze medal with a season's best of 2:10.08. That is a sensational performance.
You've got to have a long neck, actually. It's a good job. Your neck is just that, that bit longer.
Lovely legs.
Clarissa says lovely legs as well. What was going through your mind at that moment?
Just that I've got a great chance of winning, if not getting a medal, and just throw myself at the line and, you know, leave it in the hands of the gods. Mm.
And Lawrence, have you ever had someone who's inspired you?
Well, you know, one takes inspiration from everywhere, I think, but I will always go back to Tony Hart. I mean, there was a man who could...
The mighty Tony Hart!
You know, encapsulate all the vagaries of aerial perspective through the medium of grey sugar paper.
Yes!
And not get his cuffs covered in paint. I mean, you know, what a hero.
And morph. Let's not forget morph.
What he did at weekends was his business.
And listen, what would you do with... I mean, do you like our set here? But you cast
it's very,
your
it's very Mad Max, which makes the lovely Miss Robinson rather Tina Turner-esque. And it's midst...
I'll catch you later.
Gentlemen, ladies, thank you very much indeed. Best of luck.
Tina Turner here. If you're joining us online, you'll also be part of our snapshot of the nation's knowledge. So at the end of the programme, we'll be able to tell you which town and region did best and other useful bits of information. Things like whether men really do know everything or just think they do.
I could answer that, but I would not risk one of Anne's desk stairs for anything in the world. Let me introduce you to our groups battling it out here in the studio. Those that like to test us to the limit. But what is their limit tonight? The examiners! Or those busy plying us with food and drink as we fly off on our holidays. It's our cabin crew! Could you just direct us to the emergency exits, please? There, and yes, lovely, thank you very much. And just like on the planes, you won't be able to get out because ours are locked. Let's cheer those who fanatically give their all to their favourite sport. They are our football supporters! Let's have a word with Paul Goldsmith. Paul, you use acronyms to help you, don't you?
Yeah, what I do, if I have a list I want to learn, I take the first letters of the words and make a sentence out of them. So let's take FA Cup winners from the 1980s. You'd have William tried to make eggs, make liver, cooking was lousy, which is West Ham, Tottenham, Manchester United, Everton, who cheated their way past the mighty Watford, Manchester United, Liverpool, Coventry, Wimbledon, Liverpool.
And so do you use that, you know, in shopping lists or other
stuff? Well, I just finished my MBA at Cass Business School in London, and I use it to revise for exams. Very useful.
Mm. And how do you think you're going to do this evening? How's your general knowledge?
It should be okay. I do read a lot of rubbish.
Do you?
Yeah.
What do you read? Where do you get your information from?
I read the paper every morning on the train. Mm. I have to read lots of different things for my job in PR. So... You know, and I read the programme at Watford, obviously, which gives me lots of interesting information.
There's bound to be questions on that here this evening. I'm sure. Good luck to all of you, football supporters. Then, of course, we've got those who keep everything together on the home front, know everything on a need-to-know basis. There are beautiful domestic goddesses. All right, ladies. Looking great, but do they know more than those trusty chaps they have to call on when the pipes freeze or the boiler blows up? It's the plumbers! Hooray! And trouble there this evening, and they may know how to sell us a house, but will their scores include their commission? They are our estate agents! You do know you're going to get a hard time tonight, don't you?
I do.
Yeah.
We've already had a hard time.
Yes. But you're all right with that?
Oh, we're fine.
Good stuff. Now then, there are, of course, 300 people in the studio. We'll get to know more about them a little bit later on.
Right, tonight's quiz has already been tested across the country, which is how you'll know how you rate. It's astonishing how competitive everyone is. I know I have people coming up to me after every test the nation wanting to tell me how brilliantly they've done. I'm sure you have that, Philip, too.
I have, actually, but scarily, they asked me how I've done, and I have done the test. I did it yesterday in rehearsal, and Colin has marked my score, and you'll find out how I did a little bit later on.
Well, indeed, our resident brain is here as usual from Queen's University Belfast, psychologist Dr. Colin Cooper, or Superman Cooperman, as I like to call him. And with him tonight, Jane Allen. She is a true quiz queen. She actually started the country's largest quiz association. Now, Colin, it's all about general knowledge this time, which is different from our IQ test.
Absolutely, yes. Well, previously, we've been measuring how well and how quickly you can think and reason. But today, it's all about knowledge, just for how much you know.
And how did you put the test together?
Oh, well, first of all, we wrote 150 or so fun items. Then I did a whole load of statistical analyses to pick out the best 70 of them. And we trialled these out around the country, and we've ended up with them here tonight. And they're the sort of things that everybody should have come across in their lives. You know, nothing nerdy in it at all, I hope.
No. And quite a unique scoring system, yeah?
Yes, that's right. This is probably the first time I think anybody's tried this. We've actually got a way of allowing everybody at home, even if you're just doing it on your own, to compare yourself with the whole of the United Kingdom.
Yeah, OK. And will we be cleverer if we're good at IQ or at general knowledge?
Well, cleverness is usually meant for IQ, but it's been found that high IQ people tend to do a bit better on general knowledge quizzes anyway. So they use their intelligence to pick up useful facts. So.
But this is about memory more, isn't it, this one?
Yes, but memory comes out separate again, so being able to memorise sentences and things is another distinct ability.
Now, Queen Jane, why are quizzes on the up, do you think?
People love them. We're an absolute nation of quizaholics. They're very sociable. People go down to the pub, pass the time like that. And TV shows then just make them even more popular.
Oh, yes, we TV shows are very, very important. Have you got any tips for tonight?
Yes. This quiz is very well-rounded. There's something for everybody in here. So if you don't know an answer, don't worry, because something you will know is bound to come up. And I've got a bit of exciting news for you, Annie.
Good.
At my association, have had a look round at other TV quizzes, and in terms of numbers of people taking part, it looks like this quiz is the biggest quiz in the world ever. So everybody taking part tonight is making history.
Making history. There we are. Isn't that great? Good crowd here. Now, there are still two more ways to play. The one that appeals to me most, a low-test tech option using pen and paper. Just write down 1 to 70, that's the number of questions. Each question is a multiple choice, so your answer to each one will be either A, B, C or D, and you put that next to each number.
Now, a new high-tech option for those permanently attached to their mobiles. You can text us your answers. It's very simple. First, turn off your predictive texting. You will need to answer each question with the letter A to D. You can type in upper or lowercase, doesn't matter. You might want to jot down your answers on paper as well, just in case, for whatever reason, you might be interrupted. Do answer each question, even if it's a guess, otherwise that will throw your scoring. After every section of questions, for those playing via their mobiles, there'll be a special number for you to text your answers to, and at the end of the night, we'll text back your score. All messages will be charged at the normal text rate, and that's the message rate, of course, for your network, and the score messages will cost a maximum of 12p.
Right, we're off. Remember to answer all 70 questions, even if you guess. Don't expect to get all the answers right, and no cheating or conferring, or your individual score will be meaningless. The test is divided into five sections. That's everyday life, pastimes, arts and entertainment, our world, and finally potluck. And after each section, we'll give you a special number for those using their mobiles to send their replies. Okay, eyes down, pencils, mobiles, computers at the ready. Good luck to everyone. Test the Nation's national quiz is about to begin. Now, the first section is everyday life. 20 seconds for each question. Question one. What's on the back of the current 50 pence piece? A, Britannia. B, thistle. C, portcullis. D, dragon. Question two. What does the E in PAYE stand for? Electric. Earn. Eat. Or employment. Question three. Which daily newspaper has the highest circulation in Britain? The Daily Mail, the Daily Express, the Sun, or the Daily Telegraph? Question four. Traditionally, how should you end a letter that begins, Dear Sir? Yours sincerely, yours faithfully, yours, or love and kisses? Question five. According to modern rules, which wedding anniversary are you celebrating if someone gives you an appliance? First, fourth, thank you, plumbers, seventh, 11th. I'm going straight to the domestic goddesses. Not if you found that easy. Yes, easy, easy. Caroline Champion,
yes.
Where are you?
Here I am.
Now tell me, how do you qualify as a domestic goddess?
I sit at home all day.
It's as easy as that.
No, we do the housework, look after the children. Make sure the house runs smoothly.
And how do you find... it's a very lucky husband who finds a domestic goddess.
That's right.
Have you got a good husband?
An excellent husband, yes.
Really?
Yes.
How does he shine?
Sorry?
How does he shine?
He does everything that I don't do.
Really?
Yes.
And tell me, on your anniversary, is he good? Does he give you good presents?
Yes, he does, Anne. On our 8th anniversary, which was brass, he made me a pair of earrings out of brass in the figure of 8.
Oh, that's lovely. Oh, well, that's very nice. Yes. So he's worth being a domestic goddess too.
He's wonderful, yes.
OK, Philip.
There was one of the questions there about sort of national newspapers, and this is Linda Campling, who's from Ascot, and you actually did have your own experience of the power of the press, didn't you?
Yes, one day we had to sort of go and photograph a property, and we normally take it on a sunny day, and this was in the summer. And it went to press, and the paper appeared, and we got a lot of phone calls that sort of week for the property. And we
more
wondered,
than normal?
More than normal. And during that morning, one of our colleagues happened to look at the paper, and we noticed that there was one of the neighbours next door that had been sunbathing in the garden, topless, and was peering over the sort of garden fence. So, we had her in full.
So this is why suddenly everyone thought, oh, I'd like to go and have a look at that house.
Oh, absolutely. It only goes to show what assets can sell a house.
So worth thinking about. Forget about having the house smelling of coffee now. Just get the next door neighbour to take a top off.
That's right.
And do we think that the people who were selling the house might have had a word with the next door neighbour and got her to do that?
Maybe, I don't know, but there were certainly a lot of gentlemen callers to the house.
Did it sell quickly?
It did sell very quickly.
Annie.
Thanks, Philip. OK, the next section of everyday life, ideas and beliefs. 15 seconds for each one. Question six. When do we eat these? Shrove Tuesday, Ash Wednesday, Maundy Thursday, or Good Friday? Question seven. This is a place of worship for which faith? Christianity, Judaism, Taoism, or Islam? Question eight. What does this feng shui symbol mean? Harmony and balance, strength, love, or prosperity? Question 9. This object is a symbol of which religion? Catholicism, Hinduism, Islam, or Judaism? Ten. What star sign does this animal represent? Aries, Capricorn, Libra, or Sagittarius? Right, plumbers, I suppose it's a blessing that you've turned up on time, isn't it? Now, is it easy so far? If you're happy, clap your hands. Blue is obviously a very popular colour for plumbers.
Water. Water.
Water.
Water.
Water. I see.
Representing water, I think.
I see. Oh, no.
Yeah.
This is Jamie, Jamie Bradbury. Been a plumber for 15 years.
About that. Yeah.
How's your memory holding up tonight?
About okay, I reckon.
Yeah.
And not the sort of man that would forget anything vital?
Not at all, no way.
Of course you wouldn't.
Never.
Would you like to tell me first of all, what's an olive?
It's,
Plumber talk, here we go, plumber talk.
It's a little bit of, copper sort of stuff.
Yeah.
That basically clasps onto a pipe basically makes the joint when you tighten it up.
I mean, you know, I'd be right in saying, gents, a fairly vital piece of plumbing... Yeah, vital. Right, OK, what happens when you forget one?
It all goes a bit wrong.
And what did you do after forgetting your olive?
Well, I was actually freezing a pipe in this council estate in Fulham, and I was about 3 or 4 storeys up. And I had to freeze this pipe, so anyway, froze it, put the cut in a valve, tightened it up, whacked the ice plug off, and that was it. It just flooded the whole building.
How many floors?
About 3 or 4 floors.
Yeah. Really. So, anyone who's having you round on Monday for a bit of plumbing, this is the face that you should be looking out for.
My nickname from all the boys was Olive after that.
You got 6 out of 10 so far.
Is that it?
Yeah, I'm afraid so. But listen, there's plenty of time, you know, to pick it up. Plumbers, how do you think you're doing? Yeah. Currently bottom. Loads of time.
We're not surprised. Still on everyday life. Now, these questions deal with home and family. 20 seconds each. Question 11. On the internet, what are Lycos and Google? Computer viruses, search engines, computer languages, or web characters? Question 12. What's traditionally regarded as the main meat ingredient of shepherd's pie? Is it ham, lamb, pork, or veal? Question 13. The BCG vaccination is used to inoculate against which infection? Tuberculosis, mumps, measles, or rubella? Question 14. Which of these would you be least likely to find in a toolbox? A jigsaw, a gridiron, a plane, or a spirit level? Question 15. What's the equivalent of gas Mark 6? Is it 170 degrees centigrade? 190, 200, or 220? I expect the estate agents think it can be anything you want it to be. That's the end. That's the end of the first section of questions. Those on their mobiles, you should now have 15 letters waiting to go. So here's the number to text. 07797 80 80 81. And remember, the message will be charged at your usual text rate.
With the examiners now, this is Rosemary Harris from Brighton. What do you examine?
I and some of my colleagues, students from all over the world, English language speaking skills.
How does it feel for an examiner to be examined this evening?
Well, we should ask everybody else, but I think it's probably very good for us. to be done as we would be done by.
Suddenly you found yourself at the sharp end.
Exactly. Not suddenly, because I try to do it quite often. I think it's a really salutary thing to be on the other side of the table.
Good for you. And have you ever suffered from sort of exam nerves yourself?
Extremely, yes. I took a minibus driving test not very long ago and I was so nervous that I failed. But the upshot was that I gave up driving altogether, and I feel a great deal better for it.
Never again.
Exactly.
And students have in the past brought some quite extraordinary things into their exams, haven't they?
They have, yes. They have to talk about a topic, and they're supposed to bring an object to illustrate it, or a photograph. And one very shy little Spanish girl brought a very large bird cage, because she was going to talk about her pets, and when we took the cover off, inside was a venomous-looking parakeet, which hadn't been told that it was not part of the exam. So it proceeded to screech and squeal and flutter and flap.
But it wasn't giving any of the answers.
It didn't get the answers right. But she was not a very shy little girl by the end of this, because we both laughed so much that by the time it had left the classroom,
How do you think you're doing this evening?
So-so.
So-so. Examiners? So-so? You're currently top!
Yay! It's very early days. Now, Carissa, how do you think you're doing?
I should think appallingly.
Oh, really? I didn't think you were going to be modest, Carissa. I thought you'd just automatically assume you'd be head of the class.
No. My problem is that I never tend to give the right answers because I'm always trying to think of the double take.
Right. But you are a trained barrister. Is that the reason?
Well, they're always trying to think of the double take as well, yes.
How bright do you think you actually are?
Well, when I was destitute and down and out in my treatment centre as a chronic alcoholic, they worked out that my IQ was 196, but I wasn't terribly impressed.
That's a fantastic IQ, isn't it?
Well, I think it's probably impossible. The psychologist who tested it was named as Druggy Duggy, so...
Josie, can I say how beautiful you're looking this evening?
Thank you very much. Can I return the compliment? You're looking
right. What are you in tonight? What's the?
I'm in Gibo.
Oh, right. I'm in Vivian Westwood.
I could
tell.
Thank you.
Should we get on with the quiz? Now, do you suffer from exam nerves?
No, not really. But when I was doing my exams, I was one of the girls who had all the mascots kind of laid out on the desk.
Okay. Have you got a mascot with you?
I have, actually. Got Minnie Me right here. And she's doing her job because I feel like I'm doing quite well so far, I have to say.
You're not doing badly.
Okay.
11 out of 15 you've got at the moment.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
Ed, which group are you rooting for tonight?
I'm up for the cabin crew. I'm just sucking up with them in case they can get me an upgrade next time I'm back.
Well,
if any of them fall asleep, I do reserve the right to go over and wake them up and ask them to want them to eat.
Who have you got least faith in?
The plumbers. I tell you, all I'm saying is, if next year the licence fee goes up, it's because there's 50 plumbers sitting there on an hourly rate.
Philip, where are you?
I'm over here. Colin, can knowledge help in our everyday life?
Yes, there's a big literature on this, and knowing things is one of the big predictors of how well you're going to do in your job. You know, Clarissa and the goddesses will know how to stop a sauce from curdling, for example, mm-hmm. whereas the rest of us wouldn't.
But there are all sorts of different parts to knowledge, aren't there? I mean, knowledge can be a great many different things.
Yes, but what we've actually done here is done some statistical analyses to make sure that what the questions we're giving here all measuring sort of general knowledge, nothing sort of too specific.
And isn't it, Jane, just, you know, sort of useless information that we're gathering?
You never know when a little gem of trivia is going to come in useful. And going on from what Colin was saying, it's not just useful with work. Good general knowledge is useful in your social life. It'll boost your confidence, make you the darling of the dinner parties, and according to your web, you've had a poll going to find out what sort of person you'd be attracted to. 81% of respondees say that they like people that are a bit brainy. So it might even help there too.
And it helps to be a good listener.
Absolutely.
Okay, listen very carefully. Eyes down. Here we go.
On to section two, past times. We're going down memory lane. 15 seconds for each answer. Watch the pictures. And those on their mobiles, you need to start a new message. Question 16. Where did this rock and roll star live? Was it Xanadu, Neverland, South Fork, or Graceland? The 17. Which play wasn't penned by this writer? Romeo and Juliet, Richard III, Twelfth Night, or Edward II? Question 18. What is this scientist's claim to fame? The theory of relativity, genetic theory, splitting the atom, or the origins of man? Question 19. This is a self-portrait of which artist? Rembrandt, Cezanne, Renoir, or Botticelli? Question 20. What was this historical figure known as? The Lady of the Lake, the Lady of Montreux, the Maid of Orleans, or Lady of the Sword? Now, Clarissa, I've heard you boast that you're good at history.
Yes. I like history. I feel safe with it. It's happened.
Okay. Has your knowledge been put to the test?
Well, there was an occasion when I was egged on to go in for Mastermind, and I picked as my subject Henry VIII, because I feel I have a lot in common with Henry VIII. And girth, birthday, love of food, you know. I'd happily behead everybody, really. And I got as far as the televised round, and it was in the days of my drinking, and I funked it, and I rang them up, and I said, I'm terribly sorry, my uncle's terribly ill, I've got to go to Australia. And they said, oh, that's awful. Well, do ring us again when you want to come back. And I never did. But somebody did Henry VIII, and I got more answers right than he did.
So a great missed opportunity.
Well, I'd probably have fallen out the chair.
Okay.
I'm in amongst our domestic goddesses now. One of our domestic goddesses is Kate Batty. Hi, Kate. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you, yeah.
How do you think you're doing this evening?
So.
15 out of 20 so far.
Not too bad.
Happy with that?
Yeah, not too bad.
Your teacher taught you a novel way to remember Shakespeare. There was a Shakespeare question in there.
That's right, yes. Mr. Potts, my English teacher, when we were sort of doing O-levels, he used to always get us to read out in regional accents. So whenever I remember sort of quotes from Macbeth, they're always either Brummies or Scousers or sort of Cockneys or something.
So can you remember any of it?
Is this a dagger I see before me?
It deserves a round of applause, I think, for sure. Oh, damn you. So as far as the knowledge is concerned, ladies, where do you get your domestic goddesses? Where do you get your knowledge from? Whereabouts do you get your...
Mainly
your
off the internet.
Yeah? How about you?
I just like listening to quizzes and watching quizzes.
Watch a lot of quizzes on telly? Think it's helping you this evening?
No.
Let's see. Annie?
I must say that Liverpool accent was absolutely brilliant. Not just a domestic goddess, is she? We're still in memory lane, past times. All questions in this section are related to the 20... Okay, question 21. Who spoke those historic words? Buzz Aldrin, Jim Lovell, Neil Armstrong, or Michael Collins?
But I want to say one thing to the American people. I want you to listen to me. I'm going to say this again. I did not have sexual relations with that woman, Miss Lewinsky.
Question 22. Who was the independent prosecutor who uncovered evidence of the Clinton-Lewinsky affair? Was it Vernon Jordan, Kenneth W. Starr, Harold Ikes, or Charles Ruff? Question 23. At her wedding, what did the Princess of Wales stumble over? Was it her dress, her bridesmaids, her words, or her curtsy?
Earlier on today, apparently, a woman rang the BBC and said she heard that there was a hurricane on the way. Well, if you're watching, don't worry, there isn't. But having said that, actually, the weather will become very windy, but most of the strong winds, incidentally, will be down over Spain and across into France.
Question 24. What year was that? 1985, 1987, 1989, or 1991?
Where there is discord, may we bring harmony. Where there is error, may we bring truth. Where there is doubt, may we bring faith. And where there is despair, may we bring hope.
Question 25. Who was Margaret Thatcher quoting? Was it Winston Churchill, St. Francis of Assisi, William Shakespeare, or St. George?
So let's find out how our celebrities are doing so far. How are you doing?
I have absolutely no idea.
I do.
Okay, good.
18 out of 20.
I demand a recount. Something's gone wrong there.
There were a lot of clips there. Do you find that it's easier to remember something if you can visualise?
Yeah, I mean, that's one of the disadvantages of being this shallow all the way through, is that you tend to only, you know, see the things in the way that they are. You never really understand them. You never penetrate.
Well, that's your problem. Sally, we were talking about pub quizzes and said, you know, your dad had the pub, but there's no pub quiz in the Rovers.
No, there isn't.
But did go out pub quizzing with other members of the cast.
Oh, yeah, there's one in Lim, where my friends Saran Jones and Chris Liston live. And we go there sometimes. We just get too drunk now and forget where we were there.
So you were never any good
at that? Which is Coronation Street.
How are you doing this evening?
I don't think
Were there a few you didn't know that? You're not blonde, you just said that.
I know. Dishwater.
You are actually doing very well, I've just been told. Yes, you are.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't have your score, but you're doing very well. We'll uncover that for next time. There is someone in the studio who is doing extremely well. There is only one person, apparently, in this entire studio who's got all of them right. That person is in the Domestic Goddesses.
Oh, yeah!
Stand up, Carol Shaw! Carol Shaw in the Domestic Goddesses. Where are you? Oh, that's interesting.
Oh, brilliant!
Well done to you. I thought she was going to keep herself quiet for a moment. Well done to her. We'll see whether or not she can keep that out throughout the rest of the programme. Anne.
I'm so pleased about that. Just keep it up, please. We're still on Fast Times, taking us through the ages. Now, look carefully at the pictures. 20 seconds per question. Question 26. What civilization did these images come from? Ancient Rome, ancient Greece, Celtic, or ancient Egypt? Question 27. These items are from which period? The 1940s, the 1950s, the 1960s, or the 1970s? Question 28. These buildings are from which period? Norman, Saxon, Tudor, or Victorian? Question 29. These images are from which decade? The 1900s, the 1910s, the 1920s, or the 1930s? And Question 30. From what period do these images originate? Hanoverian, Tudor, Stuart, or Elizabethan? And that's the end of the second section of questions. Those on their mobiles, hold your horses. The number you are going to text your answers to is a new one for questions 16 to 30. You have to text this number now. It's 07797 80 80 82.
Colin, with the history questions there, there'll be a lot of people who would have watched that section come up and gone, oh, John, just absolutely no good at history. What do you do if you're no good at something like that?
Well, that was my reaction as well, I must admit. I used to hate all that sort of stuff, giving an IQ test any day. But basically, the message is don't panic, because there's lots of other interesting stuff coming on. We've got arts and entertainment and the natural world and all that sort of thing. So, you know, nobody will do wonderfully well at every single area.
Battle through what you don't know and get onto the stuff. There'll be stuff that you do know. And Jane, is it? Are we better at quizzes if we were good at school?
Not necessarily, no. You need to be bright. You need to have an interest in the world around you. Good memory is helpful. But you don't necessarily have to be an academic genius to be good at general knowledge, no.
Okay, well, we've got some people in the studio here who are proving at the moment not to be academic geniuses, and I can tell you who's currently bottom. The group bottom in the studio at the moment, this is going to be very popular, it's the estate agent!
It's all working out perfectly. On to section three, which is arts and entertainment. Cabin crew, you surely know everything about entertainment. Not as many suntans as I thought, actually. What about estate agents? Can you be very entertaining? Among themselves. And my soulmates, the domestic goddesses. Yeah! They're going to win. It's going to be easy. Here we go, fun and games, 20 seconds each. Question 31. In which game can a pawn become a queen? Chess? Draughts? Thank you, canasta, bridge. That's cabin crew for you. Behave. Question 32. What sport is normally associated with the hacker? Rugby, basketball, polo, or tennis? Question 33. Which of these isn't a character in Cluedo? Colonel Mustard, Miss Scarlet, Captain Peacock, Professor Plum. Question 34. Which football team are known as the Toffees? Southampton, Everton, Fulham, Watford. Question 35. Which annual British sporting event takes place over a course 4 miles, 374 yards long? Is it the Grand National, the London Marathon, the Derby, or the Boat Race? Darren, are you with us, dear, or have you fainted?
No, I'm here.
I'm quite upset you haven't come in your shorts tonight, Darren.
I thought about it. Yeah, I thought about it after the last time we met, when I showed you my chest. And
you did, on the weakest link. It was very exciting. The trouble was you weren't there for long on the weakest link.
No. I'm here for a bit longer tonight.
Yeah, OK. Now, do you like watching sport as well as competing?
Yes, are definitely.
Could those two behave at the back, please?
Still laughing at the come in the shorts.
Is Lawrence bothering you, Josie?
Not at all. He's a joy.
Sorry?
He's a joy.
Is he?
Sorry.
Even the cuffs?
The cuffs, everything. He's a sartorial god.
Let's ask Darren, do you want to know your score?
No.
No. We understand.
Good.
Josie, would you like to know your score?
Oh, go on then.
You've got 23 out of 35.
That's not bad. Yeah. That's not too bad.
Well, if by Darren's standards, it's very good. No, Darren, you've done terribly well.
Are you surprised?
Not as well as you would have done if you'd come in your shorts for me. Now, I understand you're rather good at board games, Josie, aren't you?
I do like chess. I favour chess. The others take or leave them, but chess I get quite competitive at.
It's very blokey to play chess.
Do you think so?
Yeah, who taught you to play chess?
Some Russian masters. I went there for 7 years as a child. No, I actually taught myself. Books taught me.
Really?
Yeah.
And have you competed in chess competitions?
No, not at all. It's just me and my friends, but it's the one game that it hurts if I lose.
Okay. Clarissa, are you sporty?
Well, not these days.
No.
But it might, except
in
for
your
that.
Drinking days, perhaps?
No, before my drinking days.
Okay.
It might surprise you, now I was captain of games at school, and I was actually offered a place in the Olympic junior swimming team.
Good heavens.
Yeah.
What was your,
backstroke.
Backstroke.
I've always been better on my back.
They're going to get out of hand, these celebrities. Anyway, this round is popular culture. There's a clip with each 15 seconds per question.
Follow me. Give the ring to Frodo. As you wish. I care not.
Question 36. Where were the Lord of the Rings films shot? Was it Ireland, New Zealand, Canada, or Alaska?
No more today! You've had enough! Oh my God, you've had enough! Look! Look! Look!
Question 37. In Fawlty Towers, Manuel came from which Spanish city? Was it Madrid, Seville, Barcelona, or Malaga? Question 38. Two members of ABBA went on to produce which hit musical? Was it Phantom of the Opera, Mamma Mia, Miss Saigon, or Chitty Chitty Bang Bang?
Right, you two. Right, come on. Just pick up that lot there. Pick them up. Get him inside. Come on, get him inside. It's all very well you saying pick them up. You can pick them up. You can't put them down because they're all sticky. And they stick to you. They do.
Yeah, well, I'll show you the way to pick up sticky paper. This is how you do it. Watch this, watch this. Just bend down and just get a grip like that. Doesn't stick to anything. That's the way to pick up sticky toffee papers.
Question 39. Which of these wasn't a womble? Madame Shelley, Great Uncle Bulgaria, Pootle, or Tomsk?
Oh, Reg, you're dealing with now.
Oh, pack it in, Nick. You too, Ali.
No, he started it. You all did. All day long, that's all I've heard. And I've had it right.
Ali!
Oh.
Nick! Nick, stop it! You've
got to get missus to do it now, have you?
Dead!
Oh,
Question 40. When was the first episode of EastEnders shown? 1980, 1982, 1984, or 1985?
Just my size.
No, I know. Leslie, I was just going to say, I can remember you were a fantastic sex symbol, weren't you, in EastEnders in those days?
So was Basil Brush.
Could you still jump over the bar like that?
Yes.
Okay. Are you
with
looking...
help.
Are you looking forward to going back?
Yeah, I've been back for a while, actually, but I'm not out on the screen yet. Yes, it's fun, I must say. It's fun.
Are you bringing the dog back with you, Rolly?
No, unfortunately, Rolly's... in the great dog's home up there.
Okay.
Which is a bit of a shame, really, because it was the only person I never had sex with on the show. Probably because I couldn't catch it.
Tell me, is Pauline going to be delighted to see you?
Is the Pope live in Rome? No.
Do you want to know your score?
Yes, please, love.
28 out of 40?
How much? That's a fiddle.
It's too good?
No, I thought it was 38 out of... Are you sure?
Yes. Sorry, only 28 out of 40.
You sure?
No, just sit down.
All right.
Philip.
With the examiners now, I was going to have a word about cheating in a moment, but don't worry, not about your cheating. It's fascinating to watch during the questions how everybody relaxed during the clips. They're all swaying from side to side during the ABBA clip, but over here, during the Wombles, the entire cabin crew went, "Oh." Now, if you've been texting us, we've had 20,000 people who've texted so far. Be very careful, because a lot of people are dialing the wrong number. Please concentrate. Please, it's a good job it's not IQ. So please be very careful when you're texting the number, otherwise, obviously, you won't get your results back. Right, first of all, we've got Dave. Dave Snow, you had some students who were particularly good at cheating, didn't you?
That's right, yeah. Obviously, students go to all lengths to cheat and come up with all kinds of schemes. And the best we came across was an overseas student taking an exam. And he obviously wasn't feeling very confident, so he went into the exam room as normal. And at the start of the exam, after a few minutes, he wanted to go to the toilet. So the invigilator followed him into the toilet. Well, not right into the toilet, obviously, but stayed outside. And he came back again, and he sat back down and did the whole of the exam. Right near the end of the exam, his tutor from the actual class came down, because obviously they can't be the invigilators. And he came to watch all the class leave the exam room. As they left, he was watching the sea of faces, and he thought one looked a little odd. And then he realised who it was meant to be, but it didn't quite look right. So he followed this person out of the exam room, and they went into the toilet. So, of course, they hung behind, waited, and thought this was a bit suspicious. Mm. And the whole place cleared out, and eventually this person had to come back out again, which he did. But then he was followed by his sister, who had actually sat... the exam for him, who was a year and a half older than him, had changed clothes in the toilet. And if you've ever been to Thailand, which is where the exam was sat,
that's ingenious.
There's lots of girl boys there, and they are all very pretty, the men as well as the women, and obviously he could get away with it.
Do you want to know your score?
Yes, please.
Well, for spinning a yarn, 50 out of 50, but 30 out of 40, well done. Mm. Well done. Oh. Terrific. Very good. Let's have a quick word over here with our Douglas Harper. I do want to have a word with Douglas, because Douglas used to be in the Navy, didn't you, Douglas?
Did so, yeah.
You did, and you took an exam, didn't you, Douglas?
About three a week for 7 months.
Yeah, quite a lot of exams. One you weren't particularly sure about, so you did a bit of cheating yourself, didn't you, Douglas?
Yeah, it was a wee white lie.
Yeah, okay, what did you do?
I wrote the answers to potential questions on my hands and on my wrists.
Show us your hands now, Douglas, just so that we... Okay, that's a nice idea. How did it all come horribly unstuck?
Well, I was feeling quite proud of myself after the exam, so I started to relax, and then I started swinging on my chair. And actually lost my balance, so I put my hands up to protect me. I was caught red-handed, so they make me sit it again.
And no cheating this evening?
No, not
cheating.
He's
not asking you, is he?
He is, actually.
Thanks. We're still on arts and entertainment, and this section is specifically the arts. 20 seconds. Question 41. Which of these isn't a tenor? Luciana Pavarotti, Paul Robeson, Placido Domingo, Jose Carreras. Question Question 42. In a theatre, where would you find the gods? In the auditorium, the foyer, the scene dock, or backstage? Question 43. Who's known for using preserved animal parts as art? Henry Moore, Damien Hirst, Alexander Calder, or Tracy Emin? Question 44. How many actual strings are there in a string quartet? 4, 8, 12, or 16? Question 45. Who is the current poet laureate? Andrew Motion, John Hegley, Seamus Heaney, or Ted Hughes? Little look about who's doing best at the moment. Top, were you expecting a result there, plumbers? Top are the examiners. And bottom are the essay takers. Popular result, that last bit. And that's the end of the third section. So again, those on their mobiles, a special number for you to send the answers for questions 31 to 45. You need to text 07797 80 80 83. Okay, domestic goddesses, don't let me down. Come on, liven up! I hope you're still getting full marks there. And the plumbers. Well, at least you're not last, are you? And the estate agents. And football supporters. I don't know how well you're doing at the moment. Section four now, our world. That's geography, natural history and science. The plumbers will be very good at science. The first five are picture questions, 15 seconds for each. Question 46. Where is the bicep? Question 47. Where is the dorsal fin? Question 48. Which symbol means sunny intervals? Question 49. Which part of the spider weaves the web? And question 50. Where is the patella?
I have a bit of an update on the gender war at the moment. At the moment, in the test, the men are marginally ahead of the women. Excellent. Now then, obviously as we research this programme, all sorts of bits of information come to light, and it's amazing what the members of our studio audience actually know. This is Gareth, Gareth Osgood. What do you know, Gareth?
The most isolated tree is the Norwegian spruce, and it's on the Campbell Island in the Pacific.
And do you know how you come by that piece of information?
I've no idea.
No, it's just something that's stuck in your head.
It's just a useless bit of information.
Okay, well done to you. We've got another one, actually. Way over here in our domestic goddesses, we've Val. Val Maund. Hello, Val.
Hello, Chris.
You all right?
Yes, thank you.
Enjoying it tonight?
I am, yes.
What's your useless piece of information?
The average web of a garden spider contains 30 metres of silk.
How do you know that?
Because I set quizzes, and that's one that I've...
Do you?
Yes.
So you have a big advantage here this evening.
And don't you believe it? It's much easier setting them than answering them.
Well done to you. We've got another another one over here. We've Roger Talbot. Hello, Roger.
Hi there.
What do you know, Roger?
The fact that the 1812 overture was actually written in 1880.
So it's got nothing to do with 1812.
Not at all.
And how do you know that?
Haven't a clue. Pick it up as you go along.
I have one piece of information. Do you know that it's absolutely impossible to lick your own elbow? Thank you.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
Oh.
Okay. Still on our world, the next five questions are simple science, 20 seconds each. Question 51. How many stars make up the plough? Is it 5, 7, 12, or 15? Question 52. In a rainbow, which colour lies between yellow and blue? Orange, indigo, red, or green? Question 53. At sea level, what temperature does water boil at? 100 degrees Fahrenheit, 212? 236 or 252? Question 54. What do light years measure? Time, distance, speed or brightness? Question 55. What is deoxyribonucleic acid better known as? DNA, DDT, aspirin, or vitamin D?
I'm going to tell. Sally has just turned around. She's just turned around to Lawrence and said, are you making him up?
I thought he was cheating.
How are you doing, Sally? Not good.
That was atrocious, that one. That was embarrassing. I've gone red for myself.
You've got 40 out of 55 at the moment. So that's not bad.
Is that all right?
Yeah, that's pretty good. Did you have a math teacher that helped you, someone who's particularly inspirational?
Mr. Lavendis, if he's out there, he's my favourite teacher ever because I'm almost remedial when it comes to mathematics. Mm. And he made me go in every morning and, you know, row by row. I couldn't do it now, but he was fantastic. So I couldn't get into university. Do go on, Sally. I couldn't get into university without my maths exam, you see. And he was fantastic.
And how are you finding that, Ed? It's a bit of science there. You any good at science?
Yeah, I pulled myself up a bit there. I put my glasses on now because I've been doing so badly. I've decided I need something to make me look intelligent. I put my specs on now so I can give myself a bit of nerdy air.
Do you want to know your score?
Go on.
You have got, and they're just going to tell me now, you've got 35 out of 50. So that, once again, that's a very good score.
Is that the same as Sally?
No, that's good.
I was 40, yeah. Love.
And Darren... yeah, let it not be forgotten. Darren, you're teaching youngsters at the moment. What advice do you give? What inspirational advice do you give?
Just give 100%. I think if you give 100%, then nobody can be disappointed with whatever result you give.
And do we have a couple of mini-yous coming up?
Yeah, we have a few. Definitely, I coach one boy, Daniel Plummer, who helped me leading into the World Championships. Great potential, and also my son.
Ah, he's good, is he?
Oh.
He's going to be fast.
He's scary.
We've got to say hello to one little chap who's watching the programme. This is a message we've just got, an email onto our website. It's from Dominic Elliott. Dominic, good evening to you. He says, I'm finding this all a little too hard, as I am only six. You keep at it. You keep at it, Dominic. Best of luck.
Make it easier, Dominic. We're still on our world. Five geography questions. Cabin crew, this is your chance to shine. We'll wait and see. Look at the pictures carefully. 20 seconds for each question. Question 56. Which of these is the Turkish flag? Question 57. Which city here doesn't have a public underground railway system? Question 58. Which of these is the home of the European Parliament? Question 59. Which of these is the Dutch national airline? And question 60. Which costume do you associate with Ireland? End of the fourth section. Again, those on their mobiles, the number to send the answers to questions 46 to 60 is 07797 80 80 84. Now, cabin crew, you must be the best travelled here. Where's Alex Denton?
I'm here, Anne.
Now, how about jet lag? Does it
quite
get you
bad.
Badly, the jet lag?
It does, yeah. One time I went to Florida and went to bed, wake up in the night needing to use the bathroom, eyes closed, not wanting to wake up. I walked straight out my bedroom door and it locked behind me. I was in the corridor, not wearing very much at all.
Do you sometimes forget where you are?
That's what happened.
Really?
Yeah, quite often.
I suppose the bedrooms, if they're major hotels, you look up and the furnishing's exactly the same.
It's exactly the same, but the doors are obviously in different places.
What do you think you're doing tonight?
Not really sure.
Would you like to know your score?
Yes, go on then. Embarrass me.
Well, you've done very, very well.
Really?
For cabin crew, I think you've done well.
Thank you.
She's done really... You've got a sense of humour, haven't you?
I did
46
have.
Out of 60. Very good. See? You're not just a beautiful face.
Well, our plumbers would actually like to know which airline you fly with. Just in case you happen to be wandering around naked in the corridors when they go on their holidays. And this is... You're a well-travelled plumber, aren't you? You're Dave. You're Dave Woodcock from
Kent. That's
right,
yeah.
How long have you been a plumber for, Dave?
Oh, longer than I care to remember.
I can say it's about 29 years. Yes? So when you're on your on holidays, you take photographs, don't you?
Yeah.
Don't you, Dave? What do you take photos of, Dave?
Well, I take photos of pretty coves and cliffs and pipework under
apart from the coves and the cliffs. You take pictures of foreign plumbing, don't
that's
you?
That's right, yes. That's right, yeah, I do.
So what do your family think of all this?
It doesn't go down too well when you're looking through the holiday snaps.
Did you you have people round to your house and say, no, look at this boiler. This was in Tenerife, this boiler.
Something like that,
You've taken stuff apart on holiday as well, haven't you, Dave?
Yes, I have. I took the whole family on holiday to a well-known Dutch company's holiday camp, and they had a boiler I'd never seen before, so I took it apart, put it back together again, and it didn't work. We had to call it...
Typical plumber! You, yeah, I think so. You're doing very well this evening, by the way. You've got 53 out of 60, so well done to you.
Okay.
Look at his holiday snaps.
I'm going straight round to his afterwards, yes, definitely. Now, we're on to the final 10 questions. These are a bit of a free-for-all, a sort of potluck. 15 seconds each. Question 61. If you're suffering from halitosis, what have you got? Smelly feet, bad breath, sweaty hands, or indigestion? Question 62. What type of wine do Merlot grapes typically produce? White, rosé, sparkling, or red? Question 63. Which English county has the longest coastline? Is it West Sussex, Kent, Norfolk, or Cornwall? Question 64. What is 2003 in Roman numerals? Is it M11M, MM111, DD111, or CC111? And question 65. If you're phobophobic, what do you have a fear of? Telephones, the internet, fear, or open spaces? Question 66. Which language does the word ketchup come from? Malay, Greek, Latin, or French? Question 67. In which of these countries do you drive on the right? India, South Africa, New Zealand, China? Question 68. What is the maximum term a British government is elected for? Is it 4 years, 5 years, 6 years, or 7 years? Question 69. What is the collective word for a group of owls? A parliament, a hoot, a screech, or an exultation? And finally, 70. What is Machu Picchu? A type of coffee, city of the Incas, an Aztec god, or a type of monkey? Well, that's it. The end of the quiz. Great sighs of relief around here. Again, mobile phoners, here's the number you need to text those final 10 answers to. 07797 80 80 85. And those texting, you'll actually get your scores quite soon. Although I'm hearing now that we've had a fantastic response. So give the number crunchers a bit of a chance before we get back to you. Philip.
I bet you didn't know you knew so much. Studio groups seem to be bearing up well. Congratulations to everyone here in the studio who's taken part. It's now too late to change your answers. If you've been doing the test online or interactively, then you should get your scores as I am speaking. Colin, who would you expect to do well in the studio and why?
Well, in terms of the studio groups, men usually do a bit better than women, so the plumbers may have something going for them. But those examiners, you know, I always believe in betting on a winner.
Why do the men do better than women?
Well, nobody's quite sure about that. Jane, you've got some knowledge about that more than me.
Well, yes. I mean, certainly with regards to general knowledge and quizzes, women never seem to fare as well as the men. And I think partly that's down to the ways that we learn. Men are much more likely to make a real conscious effort to go and find information out and learn things. That's particularly, you can see that when you see sports and you see our footballer over there who knows all the FA Cup winners and all of that sort of stuff. Whereas women, we absorb information. We never quite know how we know something, we just know it.
Are women embarrassed about speaking out in case they get something wrong?
Absolutely, yes, yes, that's definitely that's definitely a factor. Men will just shout out an answer even if they're not sure and won't have any embarrassment about it.
So women learn things in a different way?
Yeah.
And you said earlier on, you were talking earlier on about being a good listener. It is important to be a good listener.
Absolutely, you have to be receptive to lots of information coming at you from all angles. So certainly, yes, listening is very important.
And what about doing newspaper crosswords and pub quizzes and things like that? How is that? Does that spark up your brain?
The more exposure you have to information, the better. So yes, absolutely. If you want to improve your general knowledge, get down to the pub on the pub quiz night, read newspapers, watch news bulletins as well and things like that on TV. And instead of flicking through channels, linger, watch them for a few minutes. You'll be amazed at how much you pick up.
And what do you say, Colin, just finally to people who have played the test and done the national quiz now and thought, oh, I thought I would have done better than that?
Basically, don't panic, because a lot of things can make your score lower than it should be. You know, you might be tired or had a glass of wine too many or something like that. So, you know, and it doesn't mean you're a failure if you don't do very well. You know, there are lots of things you will be good at.
All right. Thank you very much, Anne.
Now, Clarissa, yes. which group are you backing?
Well, I was hoping for the Plumbers, because I love Plumbers. Even if they don't know what an olive is. An olive is a fruit of a tree, you know, and you eat it pickled and dried.
Which bits have you found difficult?
Anything modern.
Anything
like
modern?
Sort of the Wombles or...
Do you not watch a lot of television?
I don't own a television.
Oh, right.
I have to go out to see you, Eddie.
Oh, dear. Now, Lawrence, who are you rooting for?
The domestic goddesses. I mean, look at them. Look at them. Lovely.
They're rather beautiful. Do you wish you were a domestic goddess, or do you think you are a domestic goddess?
I wouldn't mind being a domestic god, I have to say.
Oh.
But after the Queen video, you know, the I want to break free thing, I mean, you know, surely it's all got jumbled up now. But there are no house husbands there. Where are the boys? Mm. And where are the lady plumbers as well?
Are you a bit of a cook?
No.
No.
No, 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 no.
Because actually your cuffs would get very messy if you cooked. Let's have a look at those cuffs.
Changing nappies is the big problem with cuffs like that.
How do you think you've done this evening?
I don't know.
Ah. Is that modesty?
No, I don't know.
Okay.
I don't have the answer.
You don't have the answer. Okay. Josie, it's a bit like being back at school.
Yeah, completely like being back at school, but more fun.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who are you backing tonight?
I'm split. The cabin crew. Yay! I'm a frequent flyer, honey. I got your back. And also the football supporters, but only those that support Liverpool.
Oh, Josie, how have you become a Liverpool supporter?
As well you know, Anne, I spend a lot of time there doing Merseybeat. I've developed a fabulous Liverpudlian accent, which I know you know about. And,
I do.
I know you criticised my accent once on The Weakest Link, but it was in fun.
Oh, I'm being nice tonight, Josie. Okay. I'm sure you've got a brilliant Liverpudlian accent.
I haven't tried it yet. But, being in Liverpool, I go and see the matches. A friend of mine goes out with one of the players. So, yes, Liverpool, definitely
my team.
Oh,
that's terrific.
Mm.
Now, Ed, which football team do you support?
I don't really like football, and I'm not a big fan.
Oh, wouldn't he boo? None of the football supporters, you missed the last half of the England-Macedonia match to even be here tonight. Football supporter can you be? We're football supporters, but there's a chance of getting on telly.
Have you noticed any cheating?
I didn't even know cheating was possible. If I'd known, I would have been cheating the whole time. I looked at Leslie's hands at one point when the EastEnders question was coming up.
Right, OK. We're about to break for the lottery results and the news. Now, you've got 30 minutes to rest before we return with the answers and the chance to check your score.
And I can already tell you that 50,000 people have played online. 25,000 have texted their answers.
See you back in just half an hour.
Don't miss it.
We'll be right back.
The crash site is in a remote location, approximately 20 miles northeast of Holby.
The rescue teams are here. No one's going to die.
It's taken the time of the tunnel.
Go for it!
The new series of Casualty begins with an unmissable...
Robinson and Phillip Schofield have the answers to the national quiz.
National Quiz, the biggest ever live interactive general knowledge test. Time to find out the answers and just how much we all know. Please welcome back our hosts, Anne Robinson and Phillip Schofield.
Wonderful atmosphere here, and it's time for Test the Nation Part 2. The answer's coming up shortly. But, Philip, we have had an amazing response.
Yes, incredible. It looks as though Test the Nation has broken new ground tonight with 25,200 people texting their answers for the first time and 75,500 playing online. And, of course, because the test stays online, that number can only increase. So, well done.
And we'll know shortly the person who scored the highest taking the test online. I hope it's a woman. Whoever it is, I'll be chatting to them before the end of the evening.
So I've been watching the faces of our groups, anxiously waiting to find out how they got on. We'll give them some more encouragement in a moment. This programme is nothing if not totally interactive. Thank you for your emails. Tell Mr. Schofield, says Paul Whiteside, my wife can lick her own elbow. Married for a number of years. Throw that down there. And also we've Ed Rawston says, I have a friend who can lick both his elbows at once. That's extraordinary. It should be in a circus. He's called Bernard McGregor from Hereford. Well done, Bernard. Now then, let's meet the rest of our groups now. They can hold a steady nerve and balance a stiff drink at 30,000 feet that has their nerve held tonight. It's the cabin crew! Cheer on their team and make enough noise as we've seen here tonight, but can they prove their worth in other fields? The football supporter! Those that keep everything ticking over at home, but can they prove their worth here tonight? Our beautiful domestic goddesses! Yeah! They know how the pipes fit together. In fact, some of them take photographs of them. Will they flood us with their knowledge tonight? It's the plumbers! They have the gift of the gab when it comes to selling you a home, but will that be enough to bring them out on top? They are our estate agents! They appear to have superior knowledge when they're testing us, but how much do they know when we test them? Our examiners! And of course they have all the glamour and the brains. How will they fare tonight? They are our celebrities!
It's interesting to see how people react when they're up against it taking part in a quiz.
Good evening. What is your name?
Mind your own damn business.
Help! For God's sake, somebody help!
What a bloody game.
Yeah, like being married to him. Trivial Pursuits.
So, one other question. Name the Cuban leader who's been in power since the revolution of 1959.
Fidel Castro.
Yeah, you know it now, yeah? But what did you say
then?
Tell them. What did you say then? What did you say then?
Fray Bentos.
I'm really bloody sick of this!
Have to take our hats off to our celebs here in the studio because you don't have to be here. You stuck your necks out on the line. We'll give you scores if you want us to a little bit later on. But Darren, you were saying earlier on that your son looks like he's going to be a particularly fast runner, but you're really quite competitive with him, aren't you?
Yeah, very competitive. We went down to the local stadium a few weeks ago and I raced him and I beat him, and I went, yes. He's only four. And I put my hand, I was going, yes, yes. So a little while after that, he goes, he wanted another race, but he didn't want to race me. He wanted to race his mum.
I wonder why.
So I said, oh, why don't you want to race me? He goes, oh, last time you beat me. And it's just the way he is.
And you reckon he's got a big future, do you?
Oh, yeah, definitely. He went to his sports day, and he came first in two things, and second in the other, and he was really upset, really disappointed, and, you know, it seems like I'm breeding a little monster there.
I think humility is also good in a sportsman, though, isn't it?
Oh, probably. Yes,
just
definitely.
A little bit. Clarissa, you were quite competitive at school, weren't you?
Yes, I was very competitive. I remain competitive. Humility is good in a cook, but not in anything else, really.
What about your mother? Didn't your mother give you advice with boyfriends?
Yes. There was a boy next door who used to come over the wall and play cricket with me. Christopher, he proposed me with a ring from a Christmas cracker when we were five. A bit expensive cracker. Best offer I had, you know. I always beat him at cricket. And my mother said, Clarissa, if you want to get on with boys, you have to let them win sometimes.
Did you listen to her?
I'm single.
Thanks, Celebs. Anne.
Now, Jane, is it true that men are more competitive than women?
Well, Annie, how competitive are you?
Oh, well, I'm fantastically, pathetically competitive about everything. Table tennis, cookery, television, anything I'm competitive about.
I absolutely knew you'd say that. Most women are much more reserved, but I'm like you. I think it's down to the red hair.
Is it?
Absolutely.
But perhaps whether you have brothers or there are...
It might be down to sibling rivalry, possibly, but my money's still on the red hair.
Colin, what are we going to find out about ourselves at the end of tonight?
Right, well, because we've toted this test around the country and tested it on a random sample of people, we actually know the average score in the country. So what we're going to do in a few minutes is to allow everybody at home to work out something they call their quiz quotient, which will show how intelligent they are, how good they are at the general knowledge, compared with the national norm.
OK. Now, you nearly said intelligent. Do you think there's a difference?
Yes, I'm saying intelligent people tend to know more facts, but they're not the same thing.
OK, thanks, Colin. So, this is what we've been waiting for. We're on to the answers to the national quiz. Remember, you score 1 point for a correct answer, 0, obviously, for a wrong answer. The first section was everyday life. Question one. We asked, what was on the back of the current 50 pence piece? And the answer is A, Britannia, although obviously she'll be out of a job if we ever take up the euro. Question two, what does the E in PAYE stand for? Well, PAYE stands for pay as you earn, so the answer is B, earn. Question three, which daily newspaper has the highest circulation in Britain? The answer is C, the Sun. And I bet the plumbers all knew the answer. And I bet I know which page they turned to first. OK. Question four. Traditionally, how should you end a letter that begins, Dear Sir? The answer is B, yours faithfully, because traditionally, if you don't know the recipient's name, it would be a bit forward to put love and kisses. Did you get that, cabin crew?
Yes!
Question five. According to modern rules, which wedding anniversary are you celebrating if someone gives you an appliance? The answer is B. It's your fourth wedding anniversary. There's a lot of murmuring going on. That's according to modern rules. I think I'd want a divorce if I got an appliance for any wedding anniversary. Did you know that, domestic goddesses?
No.
No, I don't think they were sure on that. We're still on everyday life. The next five questions deal with ideas and beliefs. Question six, when do we eat these? Well, the picture is of pancakes being made, and in the Christian religion, they're eaten on Shrove Tuesday, so the answer is A. Traditionally, by the way, they were a good way of using up eggs and fats before the start of the Lenten fast. I'm sure football supporters, you knew that, didn't you? I bet you did. Question seven. This is a place of worship for which faith? The photo is of a mosque, the place of worship for followers of Islam, so the correct answer is D. Yes? Good. All happy? Plumbers? Yeah? No, good. Estate agents? Oh, dear. Everyone will be very disappointed the estate agents are happy. Question eight. What does feng shui symbol mean? The answer is A, harmony and balance. It is called yin and yang. Now, yin characterizes the feminine or negative side of nature, and yang characterizes the masculine or positive. I've no idea why they're clapping, but I can tell you that, you know, the estate agents are very unpopular tonight. But if... but as a matter of interest, the estate agents don't like the football supporters. Cabin crew, you don't like the estate agents, do you?
No.
Question nine. This object is a symbol of which religion? The answer is D. This is called a menorah. It's used in Judaism to celebrate Hanukkah. Question 10. What star sign does this animal represent? The answer B. In astrology, the goat represents Capricorn. Oh, a lot of murmuring here. And if you're born under this star sign, you're supposed to be industrious, efficient, organized, and patient. And the goat should not be confused with the ram for Aries. Now, I know Philip is Aries, aren't you?
Yeah, and when I took the test, I confused it. I got goat and ram mixed up, unfortunately. Did you do that as well? Yeah, I know, nightmare. Apparently, it means that I should be full of intuitive, bold, sometimes impatient characteristics, but with a... it's true. But with a fiery nature that sometimes makes me irresistible, apparently. So, Ed, you're also an Aries, aren't you?
Yeah, how did you know that?
I went for the... but I just couldn't tell it was the goat or ram, but I went for Capricorn the goat.
Did you get it right? You got it right.
I did. I got that one right.
And would you say that those just the one. Yeah. Did you get those get the characteristics? I mean, do you think that sums you up?
That I'm impatient or that I don't
say
that.
Would
you
get
on the show, for God's sake? I wouldn't. Impatient, what, me? No.
Do you read your star signs?
No, I'm not a big horoscope fan at all. I think that whole astrology thing is just nonsense, but then us Aries are all like that, you know?
What about Sally? Do you read your star signs?
Oh, yeah, I'll read them all and see which one I like.
What did it say? What did it say this morning about yours? Did it say you're going to come onto a TV show and do incredibly well?
And incredibly, just amaze everyone with your intelligence.
Well, hopefully you'll do that, Anne.
Thanks. Okay, the next five questions are on home and family. Question 11. On the internet, what are Lycos and Google? The answer is B, search engines that help you look up information on the web. Question 12. What is traditionally regarded as the main meat ingredient of shepherd's pie? Did you know this, plumbers? That's very clever. What's that noise you're making? Oh, I bet the domestic goddesses knew that one, didn't they? Exactly. The answer B, lamb, not to be confused with cottage pie, which traditionally contains beef. Clarissa, as our resident cook tonight, have you got any tips on making shepherd's pie?
Yes, what you must do is make some sort of white sauce, preferably with port or something like that through it, and just mix the meat into it. Otherwise, it goes too loose when you put the potato on top and bake it in the oven.
Oh, good. That's very helpful. Have you got that, plumbers?
Yes.
Will that be useful for you, estate agents?
Yes.
Good. Okay. Question 13. The BCG vaccination is used to inoculate against which infection? The answer is A, tuberculosis. And you might like to know that BCG stands for Bacillus Vaccine and Calmette-Guérin, after the two French scientists who developed it. I bet you knew that, domestic goddesses, didn't you? Very bright domestic goddesses. Question 14. Which of these would you be least likely to find in a toolbox? Did you know this, football supporters?
Yes.
I bet the plumbers knew this.
Yes.
How about the smug old examiners? Did you know?
Yes.
God, they're so pleased with themselves. The answer is B, a gridiron, which is used for grilling food over a fire. All the others are tools. Question 15. What is the equivalent of gas mark 6? This is the one I thought the estate agents would get, but did you get it, examiners?
Yes.
Cabin crew?
Yes.
Really, you have gas mark 6, do you? The equivalent in centigrade is 200, so the answer is C. Okay, domestic goddesses, I hope you're doing well so far.
Yes.
Thumbs up. Very beautiful. Philip.
Let's find out how our domestic goddesses are doing. In fact, let's find out how everyone is doing as we take our first look at the leaderboard this evening. And we can see that in bottom place we have the plumbers at 69%. Above them with the estate agents at 71%. Oh, a studio thrilled. We have above them the celebrities at 72%. To say I thought they'd have been a little higher than that. Above them we have the cabin crew at 74%. Very early leaderboard, of course. The domestic goddesses at 75%. Sharing that with the football supporters, which means that in top place we have our examiners, 79%. So let's go to our examiners over here. Find out. So obviously, smug group.
Oh, never. No, not us.
Happy with your result?
Ever so. Yes.
Do you think
thank
you're contributing
you.
To this result?
We're doing our best.
What about you personally?
Corner. Yes, I'm trying hard.
Yeah, thrilled.
Oh, thrilled, yeah.
What do you examine?
I examine singing and dancing and speech and drawing.
Any of that help with you?
Absolutely not nothing.
At all. No. It's funny, actually, because there's one lady over in our domestic goddesses over here. I would have to pick the one that makes run the longest, but here we go. She's called Gillian Churn, and Gillian says that she is a domestic goddess. Actually, you encompass all of the characteristics of the people in our studio today, don't you?
Yeah, because just like all of us goddesses here, I'm an estate agent. Oh. Because when the children go to sleep out, I decide which house they're going to move into. I'm also a plumber, so when the children are crying, I'm there to dry up the waterworks. Yeah. I'm also a football supporter. I'm there to support my children playing football. I'm also a cabin crew, because I'm there to help them on the plane and see to them. And I'm also an examiner when I help them with the homework.
And, of course, to them, you're also a celebrity.
Oh, yes, of course.
And even more so when I tell you that you got 11 out of 15 so far.
Oh, very good.
Happy with that?
Hey, I'm
well done, Gillian. Well done, domestic goddesses.
OK. Section two, which was past times. Now, this was down memory lane, and the first five were on famous faces. Question 16, where did this rock and roll star live? The picture is of Elvis Presley. His home was Graceland, so the answer is D. It's still a shrine 25 years after his death, and last year, 750,000 tourists went there. Question 17, which play wasn't penned by this writer? Did you all recognise this picture, estate agents?
Yes!
Extra bright estate agents. The picture is of William Shakespeare. He wrote all the plays except Edward II, which... Oh, goody goods. Which was by... Oh, cabin crew, they don't waste their time on the beach, do you? They know it was by Christopher Marlowe, so the answer is D. Question 18. What's this scientist's claim to fame? It's Albert Einstein, looking a bit odd. Nevertheless, he did come up with the theory of relativity. And in a sentence, Cooperman, give us the theory of relativity.
I think it's that clocks do funny things when you move them very fast.
He's very cool, Cooperman. Wasn't that good? Question 19. This is a self-portrait of Rembrandt, so the answer is A. He apparently sketched or painted himself when he didn't have a model, which is why there are more than 40 Rembrandt self-portraits around. OK? Question 20. The football supporters are very quiet at this time. What was this historical figure known as? Did you know the answer, Lawrence?
The Maid of Orleans.
Yeah, very good. It's the picture is of Joan of Arc, who fought for France against the English in the 15th century and ended up being burnt at the stake. And as Lawrence says, she was also known as the Maid of Orleans. So the answer is C, and Orleans was the place she liberated from the English. It's gone very, very quiet in here. Now, five questions on the 20th century. A clip with each.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Okay, who spoke those historic words? The answer is C, Neil Armstrong. He became the first man to walk on the moon on July the 20th, 1969, and almost a billion people listened live to that broadcast. Question 22.
I did not have sexual
relations with that woman.
Okay, who was the independent prosecutor who uncovered evidence of the Clinton-Lewinsky affair, which Bill Clinton was denying there? The answer is B. The prosecutor in the case was Kenneth W. Starr. And, of course, President Clinton eventually admitted the affair, sort of. Ed, did you believe him at the time?
No, I just loved the way he said it, because if that wasn't sexual relations, then there's a few prostitutes owe me my money back.
Question 23. At her wedding, what did the Princess of Wales stumble over? The answer is C. Diana got Charles's name in the wrong order.
I, Diana Francis. Take thee, Charles Philip Arthur George. To my wedded husband.
Well, he does have rather a lot of them, doesn't he? Nothing to you, Clarissa. I understand you've got far more.
I've got 11.
Really? Can you reel them off to us?
I'm sitting comfortably. Clarissa, Teresa, Philomena, Aileen, Mary, Josephine, Agnes, Elsie, Trilby, Louise, Esmeralda. Esmeralda was my father's pet pig. I was born in the Chinese year of the pig. But to get Clarissa, they argued and argued and argued about what my first name was going to be, and finally they blindfolded my mother and turned her loose in the library. And fortunately, she pulled out Richardson's Clarissa, because it was a folio version which stood on the shelves next to the Encyclopedia Britannica.
So that's what you could have been called.
Britannica Dixon Wright, that would have done.
Question 24.
Earlier on today, apparently, a woman rang the BBC and said she heard that there was a hurricane on the way. Well, if you're watching, don't worry, there isn't.
What year was that? The year was 1987, and my... That's B, my how Michael Fish and his team got it wrong. Because it turned out to be the worst storm this country has seen in 300 years. It changed parts of our landscape, and there was devastation everywhere. Okay. Question 25.
Where there is doubt, may we bring faith, and where there is despair, may we bring hope.
Who was Margaret Thatcher quoting outside number 10 after her election victory in 1979? The answer is B. It's a prayer attributed to St. Francis of Assisi, and according to Mrs. T's memoirs, her choice of words attracted, as she put it, a good deal of sarcasm. Not that it bothered her unduly. Darren, do you like a strong woman?
Ah, oh, definitely. Just like you, Anne.
Thank you. And how about Mrs. T?
Very strong lady, very
really?
Strong-minded.
But you must have been a very small boy when she was in power, weren't you?
Yeah, I don't really remember, but I just know she was a strong-minded woman.
Oh, right. Josie, Mrs. T, your sort of woman?
Only that she's a strong woman who got what she wanted. I mean, I think I disagree with her politics, given that I veer towards the left. And I think because of her, I didn't get any milk at school, I believe.
Oh, really?
Thank you.
I don't suppose it's done you any harm. You're looking very beautiful tonight.
Thank you very much.
Lawrence, you a bit keen on Mrs. T?
I couldn't finish a whole one, I mean, obviously.
Thank you. Still on past times, taking us through the ages. Question 26. Now, we asked, what civilization do these images come from? From left to right, the images are Julius Caesar, the Colosseum in Rome, and a couple of gladiators. So the answer is A, ancient Rome. I don't think the plumbers did frightfully well there, did they? Yeah. They just say they did. Question 27. Now, these images are from which period? On the left, Andy Warhol's pop art picture of Marilyn Monroe, the pop group The Doors, and a flower power VW hippie camper. So the answer is C, the 60s. Lawrence, would you call yourself a child of the 60s?
Well, I was born in 1965, so yes, so that's where I started from.
A baby of the 60s, in fact. Have you been influenced by the 60s?
I think I've been more influenced by the 1760s.
And where does the hairstyle come from?
The 1760s, definitely.
It's got a bit more flicky, a bit more Carol Smiley, perhaps.
Well, I think it's more Camilla Parker Bowles in the right light.
Is that who you're copying now?
Kind of that with a sort of a Pitt the Younger fusion.
Oh, OK. Question 28. These buildings are from which period? Left to right, there's Chepstow Castle. Now, that was built in the 11th century. There's Caerphilly Castle, built in the 13th century, and the Tower of London's White Tower, and that was built in the 11th century. They're all Norman, in fact, so the answer is A. Isn't it, cabin crew?
Yes.
Question 29. These images are from which decade? Again, from left to right. A 1925 Mercedes sports car, a flapper girl, and actor Rudolph Valentino in The Son of the Sheik. All hot stuff in the 1920s, so the answer is C. Question 30. What period do these images come from? The pictures are of St. Paul's Cathedral, and that was finished. I'm sure football supporters knew this. It was finished in 1710, wasn't it, football supporters? Oh, yes. The Great Fire of London, that was 1666, and Charles I, who was on the throne, wasn't he domestic goddesses from 1625 to 1649? Yes. Therefore, they all fall into the period 1603 to 1730, don't they, plumbers? Yes. Of course. Which was the time of the Stuarts, which is the answer C, naturally. Good questions for you, cabin crew? Yeah. Richard, where's Richard?
I'm here.
Now, do you soak up culture easily?
I do. I soak up the culture, read Shakespeare on the beach, like we discovered earlier. Visit places like Alcatraz, San Francisco, the Taj Mahal in India, places like this, as well as soaking up the sun and, of course, the sand and the sea.
Which place have you been to more than anywhere else?
New York.
New York. Is that your favourite place?
It's one of my favourite places. I do enjoy New York, yes.
And what do you soak up there, Richard?
That would be telling probably on live television, but no, I'm only joking.
We'll get you out of that embarrassment. Would you like to know your score?
Ooh, is it horrendous?
You've done fantastically well.
Honestly, you're not just saying that.
No, no.
Honestly,
no.
Don't do a weakest link on me in the right
now. No, I'll tell you. No, I'm not allowed to do it. I'm not allowed to be rude tonight. It's part of my deal.
You can't be rude to me anyway, because I love you. So
no, I know you do.
Do you?
You watch the weakest link.
Did they tell you?
Yes. We've got to get on with it, she says in my ear.
Oh, sorry.
25 out of 30.
Oh, yeah.
That's a reasonable score. Now, in the history section, apparently the men did better than the women. Yeah! Let's, Leslie's not happy with that. He's grumbling. Leslie, are you unhappy with that?
No, it's because we're older.
Is that what it is?
Yeah. So that went straight over his head, look.
Did it? Let's have a look at our leaderboard now and see whether or not that has changed. Yeah! The battle, Estate Agents now slips 67%. They're on the bottom. 68% for the plumbers. Up there, after the plumbers, we have the cabin crew at 71%. We were thinking they might be a little better red, but there you go. Above that, we have the celebrities at 72%. With the footballers, football supporters 72% sharing with the celebrities. That's something we didn't think would happen. We've also got the domestic goddesses at 74%, doing extremely well. And above them, we have our examiners at 81%.
Let's get a look. Quick word with our football supporters over here, who are doing extremely well. What is it, guys? How come? I mean, what's your secret?
I think the secret of the examiners is they must have had the answers. And then they still can't get 100%.
But there's always mistakes when they come to give them out anyway, when it comes to examiners.
That's where they've dropped 19%.
And what about the rest of you? All happy with your results so far?
Yeah, doing all right, yeah.
Yeah? Think you're going to win?
Yeah.
Yeah? How well do you think you've done personally?
I think I've got about 20.
Out of the whole thing? Out of 70?
Oh, no, 30.
OK, all right. Just for a minute then, right, let's continue, Anne.
Thank you. I'm very, very proud of the domestic goddesses. Well done. Great. Terrific. We're on to section three, which is arts and entertainment. Now, we're starting with five questions that come under the heading Fun and Games. And question 31 was, in which game can a pawn become a queen? Then why cabin crew always laugh? The answer is A, in chess, a pawn can become a queen when it gets to the other side of the board. Question 32, what sport is normally associated with the hacker? Now, the answer is A, rugby. And here is the hacker in action. It's the Maori dance, war dance, traditionally performed at the start of a rugby match by the New Zealand team. Football supporters, is that the sort of thing you do before a game, or are you in the pub? Very nice, that. OK, question 33. Which of these isn't a character in Cluedo? The answer is C, Captain Peacock. Now, there is a character called Mrs. Peacock. Captain Peacock, however, is from the sitcom Are You Being Served?
Leslie played Colonel Mustard, didn't you?
I certainly did, yes. A series for Granada, yeah, a series of Cluedo.
And so did you get that question right?
Yes, I did.
Because I did notice that you looked at the hacker and went, oh, that hacker!
Yeah, no, I was... if I'd have seen those New Zealand guys doing their stuff, I would have known what it was. But when you see it on their hacker, you get confused.
It didn't ring a bell.
Yeah, and Mrs. Peacock, actually, in the clue I did was the lovely Joanna Lumley.
Ah, and she make a fine.
Yeah, and Jerry Hall was Miss Scarlet.
Lawrence, what would you play if you were going to play a Cluedo part? What would it be?
I'd probably play one of the blunt instruments.
Bit of lead piping.
Yeah, why not? I'm built for it.
Oh my God! Moving on, Anne.
Okay, question 34. Which football team is known as the Toppies? The answer is B, Everton. We've got any Everton supporters there? Oh, just one! Got Liverpool supporters though, haven't we?
Yes.
Apparently the name originates from a toffee shop called Omar Noblets, which was round the corner from Everton's ground at Goodison Park. Question 35. Which annual British sporting event takes place over a course of 4 miles, 374 yards? It's the boat race, answer D. That's the annual race between Oxford and Cambridge University, and it runs on the Thames between Putney and Mortlake. And next year will be the 150th boat race. Now, we're at the halfway point. Are you feeling good about it, estate agents? Thumbs up?
Yes.
How about the plumbers?
Yes.
The domestic goddesses?
Yes.
The examiners?
Yes.
Cabin crew?
Yes.
Is the football supporters?
Yes.
They're all very confident. OK, now the five questions on popular culture. Question 36.
Follow me. Give the ring to Frodo.
Okay, where were the Lord of the Rings films shot? The answer is B, New Zealand. The clip you've just seen was from the first film, The Fellowship of the Ring, which was part of Peter Jackson's trilogy, because director Jackson is a New Zealander and he's actually done wonders for his country's tourism. Question 37.
No more today! You've had enough! Oh my God, you've had enough! Look! Look!
Thank you, Admiral. Admiral, thank you. That's enough. Thank you. Anything else we can do for you?
Manuel came from which Spanish city? The answer is, of course, C. Here's confirmation.
Ready! What's been going on in here? Well, we tried rearranging the furniture, but it didn't really work. Manuel has old coats.
Oh.
It's all right, he's from Barcelona.
Question 38. That's got the cabin crew going. Two members of ABBA went on to produce which hit musical? The answer is B. ABBA's Benny and Bjorn composed and produced the original Broadway production of Mamma Mia, which features lots of their hits, including the song Waterloo, and there are actually still 12 productions running across the world. Question 39.
Right, you two. Right, come on. Just pick up that lot there. Pick them up. Get him inside. Come on, get him inside. It's all very well you saying pick them up. You can pick them up, but you can't put them down because they're all sticky.
Which of these wasn't a womble? The answer is C. Pootle. He was one of the flumps. Domestic goddesses, did you get that?
Yes!
Good, good. Plumbers, did you get that?
Yes!
Not sure they did. Question 40.
Get, get!
Oi! Hey,
push
them out. Get him back. Oh, take care of yourself. Me? You're far. Look at my shirt. My bleeding shirt.
When was the first episode of EastEnders shown? Well, that clip went out at 7 o'clock on the 19th of February 1985.
Oh,
so, a bit disappointing that. The answer is D. Leslie. That was 18 years ago. You were the first person on screen, weren't you?
Yeah.
Can you remember what you...
You got the question wrong.
And you said... You uttered the first lines.
Yes, I did.
Which were?
Of course, sticks in it, isn't it?
Oh, well done. That's very good. Did you ever imagine EastEnders lasting so long?
No, because we actually sat down. We had to watch it at Elstree, and we watched the episode going out on television, and everyone was there, production, and this... guy was sitting next to me, he said, well, that was good. He said, you were very good. He said, what did you think? I said, I don't know. I said, I wasn't too keen on the song, you know, the theme song. And he went, I wrote it.
Now the arts. Question 41. Which of these isn't a tenor? Pavarotti, Domingo and Carreras famously performed together as the three tenors. So the correct answer is B, Paul Robeson, who was in fact a bass. Question 42. In a theatre, where would you find the gods? Well, you'd find the gods in A, the auditorium, right at the very top. It's a grand name for the cheap seats. Question 43. Who's known for using preserved animal parts as art? The answer is B, Damien Hirst. This is Away from the Flock, one of the works that contributed to Hirst winning the Turner Prize in 1995. The art critic Brian Sewell said it was no more interesting than a stuffed pike over a pub door. Would you agree with that, Lawrence?
The secret with Damien Hirst stuff is not to confuse it with a buffet.
Thank you. Question 44. How many actual strings are there in a string quartet? There are four instruments in a string quartet, two violins, a viola, and a cello, four strings per instrument, making 16 altogether. The answer is D. Don't think everybody got that here. Question 45. Who is the current poet laureate? We knew that, did we, plumbers? The answer is A, Andrew Motion, in case you're wondering, plumbers, what he looks like. Here he is. He's had the job since 1999, and his most recent effort was a rap for Prince William's 21st birthday.
So plumbers, not going too well at the moment. Did you know the poet laureate? Who knew the poet?
Yeah.
You, what you reckon?
It's getting better.
Getting better?
Yeah.
You've been languishing down the bottom for the past couple of leaderboards.
Okay.
But it could get better.
It's going to get better.
Is it? Okay,
oh, yes.
Very confident. And Dave, you know, we talked to you earlier on, you know, the man who goes out on his holidays and takes pictures of foreign plumbing. How are you doing?
I seem to be doing reasonably well.
Everyone, I stand behind you for the past 10 questions, and each one you've gone, oh, damn, I don't believe it. Are you doing all right, are you?
I'm doing all right.
Are you enjoying yourself?
Oh, it's great.
Well, let's see how you've done on the leaderboard now, plumbers. You said that obviously it's looking up. Let's have a look. Here we go, the leaderboard at this state of play. We have, down on the bottom, the estate agency. 66%. Ah, everybody loves that. Plumbers at 68%. So he said it was getting better, but unfortunately not that much better. Getting better, yeah, looking up. We've got cabin crew at 70%. We have got the football supporters at 73%, along with the domestic goddesses. They've slipped. And above them with the celebrities at 75%. And we have got the examiners at 80%. Ooh, they're holding on to a mighty lead there. I think we ought to have a word with our estate agents. What's going on here? What's happening? You had all those facts.
I've got a theory, actually.
What is your theory?
We work such long hours that we don't have time for all this culture.
Do you agree with that?
I think it's true.
Spend too much time on their backsides watching TV, reading books, magazines.
Just like an estate agent.
Exactly.
You're just quick with the lines, but none of the facts.
No, none of them.
All right, Annie.
Okay, we're on to section four, our world. That's geography, natural history, and science. Question 46. Where is the bicep? Well, it's at point B in the arm. Come on, muscle man. That's very nice, isn't it? There's also actually a bicep in the thigh. Now, Darren, this is the moment I've been waiting for. Would you start? Lovely.
Later.
Okay.
Later.
We'll do that later, but just show me where your bicep is. The other one. On your thigh. I don't think he knows where your bicep is.
It's by here, lovely.
You know what a hamstring is?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. I don't think he knows where it is. I don't think he's got a clue. Question 47. Where is the dorsal fin? And the answer is D. Dorsal means relating to the back. And as anyone who's seen Jaws will know, it's the fin that sticks out of the water and scares you witless. Okay, question 48. Which symbol means sunny intervals? The answer is A, what we normally expect from a British summer, except not this year. There you are, sunny intervals there. Okay, question 49. Which part of the spider weaves the web? The answer is D, spiders produce the threads for their webs from special glands called spinnerets, and they are at the rear of the body. Question 50. Where is the patella? Well, it's at point C, otherwise known as the kneecap. It stops the knee bending the wrong way. Pretty vital, even if you're a skeleton. Okay. Football supporters, you surely knew that, didn't you? Okay, still on our world, and this section covers science. Question 51. How many stars make up the plough? The answer is B, 7. Good. Here's what you get if you join the dots. There you are. Did you get that, Clarissa?
Yes, I did.
Now, people say it looks like a frying pan. I think it looks like a fly squatter, don't you?
Well, it's a funny shape for a frying pan, but I've got some very strange shaped frying pans after I've applied them to people's heads.
Okay. Question 52. In a rainbow, which colour lies between yellow and blue? The answer is D. Green lies between yellow and blue. There we go. There it is. Question 53. At sea level, what temperature does water boil at? I hope the plumbers got this. The answer is B, 212 degrees Fahrenheit. That's the equivalent of 100 degrees centigrade. And shame if you answered A, plumbers. They're looking very confused, the plumbers. Question 54. What do light years measure? Well, they measure the distance light travels in a year, so the answer is B. Okay? Question 55. What is deoxyribonucleic acid, better known as? The answer is A, DNA for short, the substance from which all our genes are made. And, of course, no two people have the same DNA or chemical code. How are the groups faring now?
Well, I'm just here with the estate agents, who, of course, are currently extremely bottom. And, there was a bit of a murmur went up there with patella, the kneecap, because I heard a couple of them say, oh, God, I thought it was paella. So we've got mum and daughter here. We've got Hazel and Leslie Beattie from York. How are you doing? Because you're right down the bottom. But obviously the rest of the team must be dragging you down. So, have you been swatting up for this?
Well, I don't know. I agree with my colleague. I think we work too hard. We have to focus on the job so much. I do drag myself away from work every Monday to the quiz.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
And And Mum, what about you? Who's going to win out the pair of you?
Probably Hazel, but I'm actually sat in the wrong seat because I should be over there with the domestic gods.
Should you really? There's no point trying to jump out the bottom team and go ones at a third. I do actually. Oh, Hazel, I'm just getting some information. Hazel got one more. You got one more than your mum,
right,
apparently. So you're one in the lead. I do actually want to. Sorry, team, just scoot across the studio here because there was one question in there, which was where does green come in the rainbow? At the beginning of the programme, we were talking about acronyms. And you were very good at acronyms. Now, did you learn at school the acronym for that?
No.
I learned Richard of York gave battle in vain.
No, I just sung it to myself. Red and yellow and green and...
Very good. Football supporters, we'll look to see how you do on our leaderboard in a moment and whether or not that's helped at all.
He's a wonderful... I think he's a Watford supporter, isn't he?
You're a Watford supporter?
Oh, yeah. All my life.
Always alive.
Now, five geography questions. Question 56. Which is the Turkish flag? The answer is D. It represents the North Star and the Moon, images of hope against a blood-red background in memory of a battle waged against the Greeks in the 1920s. And anyone watching the matches tonight will have known that A is the Macedonian flag, then B is the Hong Kong flag, and C is the Iraqi flag. Question 57. Which city here doesn't have a public underground railway system? The answer B. The photos are of Moscow A, Amsterdam B, London C, New York D. All have public underground railway systems apart from B, Amsterdam, where they much prefer trams, boats and bicycles. Question 58. Which of these is the home of the European Parliament? Well, A is the Welsh Assembly, C is the Irish Parliament, D is the Reichstag, seat of the German federal government. So the answer is B. It's the European Parliament in Strasbourg. Question 59. Concentrate, please. Which is the Dutch national airline? The four tail fins are A, Qantas, B, KLM, C, EasyJet, and D, Olympic. KLM is the Dutch national airline. So the answer is B, isn't it, cabin crew?
Yes.
Question 60. Which costume do you associate with Ireland? The Irish costume is A. The other costumes are B, Welsh, C, Spanish, D, Greek.
Did any of our cabin crew get the tail fin wrong? Come on.
No,
you all got that right. What's Johnny Rowe, what's the most stupid thing that any passenger has ever said to you?
Well, to be honest, you do get a corker nearly every flight you do, but one that does stand out quite a few years back. I was travelling back from Orlando and I was serving this lady and her family some drinks. The question was, do you accept dollars? Not an out of the ordinary question, or so I thought, until she handed me some Disney dollars. I just sort of stood there thinking, oh, you've got to be kidding me, you know. And she was insistent they were legal tender. And I was like, well, no, madam. In Disneyland, yes, but unfortunately not on the airline.
And has anyone ever asked to sort of open a window or go out?
You do get it quite often, actually. And we're coming down the final approach onto landing. And one of the my passengers said, why can't I see the runway? Well, madam, you're looking out the side window and we're coming, you know.
You can go up front and have a look if you want to.
Yes, on the part of that.
And this is Sarah Spencer. What's the dafter thing anyone's ever said to you?
Well, it relates to your last comment, actually. I was in the back galley. We were mid-cruise, so 35,000 feet. And a lady comes into the back galley with her little boy and casually says to me, excuse me, could you open up the back door so my son can look out?
So, yeah, wrap up warm.
Exactly.
What's the temperature up there? About minus 60?
Minus 52,
Minus 52.
Yeah.
And, Johnny, do you have celebrities on your...
I'm a bit of a budget airline, actually, I'm afraid, Phil, so... We don't get to carry many celebrities, don't do celebrities.
I've used budget airlines.
Well, yeah. We haven't got Anne.
No, Anne doesn't actually use budget airlines. Any of you do first class? Do any of you do the stuff up the front? Yeah, because, I mean, you know, that's where you'll have met Anne. She's just like Terry Wogan. Terry Wogan says when he goes on a plane, he never turns right. That's very similar to Anne. Right, let's have a look at our leaderboard now. Let's see whether or not those last few questions have changed the results. At the bottom, the estate agent is 67%. We have our cabin crew at 70 with the plumbers. Not so good, cabin crew. Okay, and above that, we've got our domestic goddesses on 72. They are actually slipping a little bit. Above them, we've got our celebrities on 74%. Sherry
having second place with the football supporters, which means that this current state of play in the lead is still the examiners.
On 80%. Dan.
There is only a point between the domestic goddesses and the football supporters, actually. You're still doing OK. We're on to the final 10 questions. It's a bit of a free-for-all potluck selection. Question 61. If you're suffering from halitosis, what have you got? Smelly feet, bad breath, sweaty hands, or indigestion? The answer is B. Halitosis is another word for bad breath. Question 62. Sorry. Question 62. What type of wine do Merlot grapes typically produce? The answer is D. Merlot is a red grape grown in the Bordeaux region of France and elsewhere across the country, across the world. Question 63. Which English county has the longest coastline? It's Cornwall, D. Or, yes, very pleased about that. Almost 435 miles of coastline. Question 64. What is 2003 in Roman numerals? The answer is B, because M stands for 1,000, so two M's make 2,000 and three single ones make up the three. Question 65. If you're phobophobic, what do you have a fear of? The answer C, phobophobic means a fear of fears. And women, incidentally, are apparently twice as likely as men to have phobias. Do we agree with that, domestic goddesses?
No!
Gillian Cherm, you've got an interesting fact on this, haven't you?
I do. It's the it's the word hippopotor monstrosis quid dalior phobia, which means a fear of long words.
That's very impressive. How do you know that?
On the internet.
Oh, excellent. And I think actually quite a lot of guys are frightened of spiders, aren't they?
Yes.
Not just women. Thank you very much, Gillian. Very impressive. Question 66. Which language does the word ketchup come from? The answer is A, Malay. Thanks to the Malaysians for that fantastic contribution to world cookery. Question 67. In which of these countries do you drive on the right? Well, in India, South Africa and New Zealand, you drive as we do on the left. It's obviously a hangover from the empire. In China, should you be driving there, you need to drive on the right. Therefore, the answer is D. Question 68. What is the maximum term a British government is elected for? The answer is B, 5 years, although governments don't often hang on for that long. But the next election will have to be held by 2006. Question 69. What is the collective word for a group of owls? The answer is a parliament. A. Are they as wise as our MPs? They certainly look a lot sweeter in that picture. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, question 70. What is Machu Picchu? The answer is B. It means old peak. It's an ancient Inca city in the Peruvian mountains. It was sometimes called the Lost City of the Incas, but it's now a huge tourist destination. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is it for the... You have completed the National Quiz 2003! Hooray! Now, Philip, I know you've taken the test. How did you get on?
I took it yesterday. It was marked by Colin, so we know that I didn't cheat. And although I'd got my own star sign wrong and the boiling point of water in degrees Fahrenheit, I got 62.
62 out of 70.
But it has to be said, I didn't do very well in the IQ test. So
no, but with 62 out of 70, Philip, you might get a job in television, do you think?
I don't think there's any future for me in that, I have to say, no. Thank you, Anne. Let's give you the opportunity now. You never know, the ones who've been down at the bottom, the ones who've been at the top, could well have changed in that last group of questions, OK? So give yourselves one final round of applause. The examiners! Yay! The Gavin crew! Yay! The football supporters! Yay! Our domestic goddesses!
What about you? is it?
Not forgetting our plumbers. And gents, and the estate agents.
Okay, well, congratulations to everybody who's taken part. We now need you to add up your scores. And as we said at the beginning, it's 1 point for a correct answer. Obviously nothing for a wrong answer. You'll get a score out of 70, and our expert Cooperman has worked out a way that you can get your rating, and he's going to explain that to us, aren't you, Cooperman?
Sure, Anne. Basically, we've worked out something which we've called a quiz quotient, which is very much like an intelligence quotient that we've used before. And what this allows you to do is to compare your score against the national average that we got when we road tested the test. And the nice thing as well is that it corrects for age. So don't email me saying that no 16-year-old can possibly know the answer to such and such an item. That's already been taken care of. But anyway, if we take Philip as an example, in a minute we'll see a table like this, and it will scroll. It will come up in three parts when you see it. Philip scored 62. And if you look down the first column, that's the red column, until you see your score, 62 in this example, and then look along until you see the age band into which the person falls.
Well, actually, he claims to be in the 30 to 59 age bracket. He won't tell us which end of that is. But that does make him quite good, doesn't it? Because he's scored 139.
Yes, he gets a quiz quotient of 139. Now, most people will get quiz quotients between about 85 and 115. That's a sort of normal range.
Oh, so he's well above average.
Well above average. If you get a quiz quotient of 130 above, that puts you in the top 2%.
Okay.
And if it's 138 or above, that puts you in the top 1% of the population.
And just explain the significance of the age bands to us.
Yes, we've used the age bands because people obviously learn more as they get older. So a very knowledgeable 15-year-old wouldn't know as many facts as a very knowledgeable 45-year-old, for example. So this takes account of all that.
And finally, just if you're under 14.
If you're under 14, basically use the 14 to 19 age bracket, but don't take the results too seriously because they will underestimate your true general
just
knowledge.
A rough guide if you're
yeah,
under
just
14.
A rough guide.
OK, Philip.
Right, let's have a look now. We've been waiting all evening. It is time for our results. Okay, here we go with our facts and figures about everyone who has been taking part. I can tell you that 86,300 people have taken the test so far online, which is an astonishing number. Of course, the test is still online. You can still play if you want to. And also, 28,000 people have texted. So thank you very much indeed to everyone who took part on the web this evening. Now then, we can tell you about how our country has done. We'll split you up. So let's see now how England, Ireland, Scotland and Wales did. We can see that Scotland and Wales got 111. We can see that England got 112. And also we have Northern Ireland with 112. England in the IQ test actually got the same score in the national IQ test. They got 112. Wales were bottom actually with 110. So there you go. Well done to them. That's 112 for England and Northern Ireland. So both top winners. Give yourselves a round of applause if you're watching there. Now then, remembering, of course, that your score is out of 70. It's translated into a quiz quotient, as we were saying. So that's why the numbers are higher now. Let's have a look at towns. So do cheer, teams, if your town comes up here. We can see that at the bottom, we've got Glasgow with 111, Londonderry with 111. Oh, look at this. Actually, these are very, very similar. Newcastle, Birmingham, Londonderry down the bottom. The score goes up for Leeds, Plymouth, Aberdeen and Manchester. Still 112. This really is a hugely average score. Aberystwyth of 113. For Bristol, for Southampton, 114, which means that at the top with Brighton! It's Brighton at 115. Right, OK, how do you pick up your knowledge? Now, we've talked throughout the evening with a number of people in the studio. Domestic goddesses, a lot saying that they're sort of watching the telly during the day. Nothing wrong with daytime telly. Massive amounts of information to be got from the daytime telly, as we well know. But, of course, we've also got books. We've also got the internet. A lady said that she got her... It was Gillian, I think, said she got her massive word from the internet. So let's have a look. TV, radio, books, newspapers, talking in the internet. Who gets what from where? The brainiest people, the people who got the most knowledge, actually get it from books. 117 was the quotient there. 113 for TV and radio, along with newspapers. Talking the lowest. The lowest amount of knowledge passed from person to person, according to the people who played online, was actually talking. Okay, right, let's move on. What impact your family has on what you know? Now, this is basically the amount of people that there are in your family, the amount of siblings. So if you're in a bigger family, does that mean you know more than if you're an only child? Well, we asked people online if they could tell us that. So brothers and sisters, four or more, we've 109. We've 111 for the people with three or more in their family. That's siblings. 112 for two, 115 for one, and an only child, 110. So if we look there, we can see that one child in the family is the one with the greatest general knowledge, and the only childs have 110. Right, okay. The big one. We've been talking about this all evening. I know that Colin said that he thought that the men were going to do well here. Jane obviously disagreed with that. So this is the big one. Let's find out now who has come out on top in our national quiz test. The men or the women? And... yeah. There you go! It's the men at 114, females at 110, which means it's 5-0 to the men in all the tests we've done. Marvellous.
Okay, and what's more, never mind, next time. A massive 86,300 played online tonight. And I hope now I'm going to talk to the person who scored the highest taking the test on the web. It's George Alexander. He's from Bristol, and the amazing thing is he's only 13. And his, isn't that wonderful? His quiz quotient is 145. He got 64 questions out of 70 right. Are you there, George?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yes, you must be very pleased with yourself.
Yeah.
What did you find difficult?
Well, the stuff like, the questions that were like, well, the... I don't know.
Well, actually... well, you almost got everything right, and of course, because you're underage, that's only a rough guide, 145. Did you do better than anyone else in your family?
Well, I don't know about my mum, because she was in the front room. I don't know if she was doing it or not. But my brother said he got quite a lot, but not as much as me.
Okay, is he younger than you or older than you?
He's my twin. He's a minute older than me.
Congratulations, George Alexander. You've done fantastically well. Well done.
Obviously an incredibly bright family. Right, there's been a bit of friendly rivalry amongst our studio groups, as we know, throughout the evening, so let's put them out of their misery and tell them how they really did. Now, remember, the final score, the final scores have been adjusted for age. This is using Colin's quotient system. So our final leaderboards. Here we go. And we have, at the bottom, the estate agent! Next on that leaderboard, the final one, the cabin crew, Drew with the domestic goddesses at 115. Scores getting bigger now, the celebrities at 118. Not a bad score. Above them, who's won? The football supporters with 119, which means that our winning group are the examiners with 124. Well, examiners. So you really did. You led right from the word go.
I'm very pleased.
Yeah?
We're all very pleased, yes.
So, I mean, what is the secret here? Why do you think that you guys did so well? Is it because that you are constantly looking at papers, viewing papers?
I think we just got a general interest in all topics, so that's what we're trying to pick up all the time.
Yeah. You look thrilled.
I am.
I'm shocked, actually. Right, now then, we have to find out who's the top person in the studio. Now, I can tell you that, in fact, four people got the highest quotient within the studio. One of them is over in our domestic goddesses. Now, someone's going to give you her name. The name of the... Sheila Trott, where's Sheila Trott? Sheila Trotz! Wow, Sheila! Well done, Sheila!
Thank you.
Congratulations to you. You are one of our four highest scorers in the studio. Why, Sheila? How have you done this? Where have you get your knowledge from?
Well, everywhere, and I like quizzes and I like information.
And you're reading newspapers and reading books and stuff like that. Internet? Do you do the internet?
No, I don't do
internet.
Any
of that sort of stuff.
No.
And what do you think has been the secret? I mean, the Domestic Goddesses did very well this evening. Is it because you guys are constantly open to information? Do you think that's what it is?
Yeah.
Terrific. Well, it's been lovely having you in here. We've loved having you as our top player. But I have to say, there is one person in the studio who's actually beaten you. Now, the reason I say that is because although the quotient is the same, it's actually they got one more question right. So it was down to those sort of age groups and that quotient thing in the end. I can tell you, and I'm going to get that information as to where they are and who they are, that person is not in the Domestic Goddesses. That person is not in the Plumbers. Surprise, surprise. That person is not in the Estate Agents. It's also not in the Football Supporters. So look at this lot running now, hunting in packs now, this camera crew. So they're in between the cabin crew and the examiners. Which one are they in? Someone is the highest person. Here, in here, in here, in here! They're in the examiners! Where is the trophy? Let me have a name here. Who is the person? It is... Steve Vickers! He's at the other end! Steve Vickers, you are our winner by one question. Well done. Congratulations. Round of applause for Steve.
We've still got one more trophy to go to our brightest celebrity. Would you all like your scores very quickly? You
yes.
sure about that, Lawrence? Leslie, you've got 103. Ed, 104. Darren, you gorgeous thing, you got 107. That was fantastic,
oh, well,
Darren.
God.
Sally, 121. Josie, 126. Clarissa, 130. And Lawrence, who was so not wanting to know what he got, you are the top with 132. Good. 59 answers right out of 70. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. It's going to make a lovely lamp base.
Did we enjoy ourselves?
We did.
Yes.
Great. You've been great sports.
Well done, celebrities. Absolutely fabulous. Colin, what does that tell us? So you said at the beginning that the plumbers and the examiners would do well. You got the examiners right, but you sort of got the plumbers a bit wrong.
Yes,
there.
I thought the plumbers would because of the male advantage, and I thought the examiners would because they know to cheat, basically.
Oh, look at that. Now you've got right at the very end and they've turned on you.
Exactly.
And Jane, any surprises for you?
Yeah, I'm disappointed that the women didn't do better overall. I really thought tonight might be ladies' night.
Every national quiz we've done, the men have come out on top.
I know, gutted.
If you didn't get a brilliant score this evening, then you don't go away despondent.
Absolutely not, because all sorts of things could make your score lower than it should have been. You may not have been concentrating, or you may have had a glass of wine or something like that. So, and even if you didn't do all that well, it doesn't mean that you're a failure. There's lots of other things you're going to be brilliant at, so don't feel negative about it.
You've been brilliant tonight. Thank you both very much indeed.
Pleasure.
Thank you. Our experts.
Thank you very much. Wonderful. We've had a fantastic time here in the studio. I hope everyone watching has enjoyed themselves, including the expats living in Europe, who've emailed to tell us they've been taking part tonight.
Yes,
good?
Hello to everyone who's taken part, and thank you very much. Don't forget, if you want to check your results, the lookup table is available on CFAX page 620, and it's also on our website at bbc.co.uk/testthenation. Now, if you came in late and you want to take the test, then don't worry. As I've said throughout the programme, it will stay online for the next few weeks.
Thank you all for taking part, particularly the estate agents. They came for so much. You know, what's been fantastic is making this a truly national event. And with any luck, it's been lots of fun. You've brushed off the cobwebs from the summer and maybe even learnt a bit. And let's end by giving a big hand to our studio groups, the estate agents. The football supporters, the cabin crew. test our celebrities.
Well done, celebrities. Testimation will be back at the end of the year, testing just how much you remember about 2003. So you need to start swatting now, because as we've seen, every bit of knowledge helps.
Finally, thank you all for helping us yet again to make television history. And from the team that brings you Test the Nation, a very, very good night.
Good night.